determining how efficiently to stream the data.
Pick three. Okay, you got
you. Goes through and finds the fastest server it can find, but then, and then uses that. For bandwidth. Live.
Now what's live?
Determining how efficiently to stream the data.
Pick three. Okay, you got
Goes through and finds the fastest server it can find, but then uses that. For just bandwidth.
Okay,
mute that so that will feedback on itself.
Is there a way to test it? Test our audio? Playing the audio. Just play it and then play that.
No. Only way is to go upstairs right now and I'll go to iDGi one.
Well, can't we just
Twitch.
Do what you just did? We'll just record for a couple seconds and
then
back on that.
Oh,
and then we'll hear what that says.
That's true, because that's behind. Yeah.
That's what they're seeing, right?
Right.
Basically, yeah.
Right. Yeah, this is where I left off yesterday. Actually, it's level 2. What about me?
Would there be anywhere?
Yeah. So, now we can test this. Two. What about me?
Would there be anywhere?
No, she's fine. Yeah, actually, it's like a decent test too. Thank God no one's here. This is all boring stuff. She's fine.
You know what powers everything? Your keyboard clacks.
Yeah, actually, it's like a decent test too. Thank God no one's here. This is all boring stuff. I was gonna start to go leap feedback stuff because. I was hearing the sound. That's where you get like this weird constant echoing. Yeah. So, freakier. Experienced. I only play experience. So, yesterday, did I hear what happened in the stream? I'm playing through, and I'm going to the part where you can start to treasure the Mercury, then bring. My goal was to bring Kirill out and then gas him. Do that, right? But I decided to talk about that one bug that we didn't fix until way late. Not bug, but like there was a post about the fact that if you go into your inventory and you drop the gun, it wouldn't recognize you dropped the gun. And his whole immersion was broken from that. So I was like, I showed that. So I was like, you look, you know, at one point you couldn't, this didn't work, but we went, you know, I showed, dragged it, and so like, now it works. And but then afterwards, he's like, okay, yeah, Kirill showed up, and then the Merc backed away, so you could walk up, go down the ladder to go talk to Kirill. Then I decided to go scoop up the gun, immediately goes into my hands. Mm-hmm. They go, you have a gun in hand, yeah. Gunfire erupts. I was suddenly like, oh shit, and like ran back and like immediately ducked, got in this crazy fight. I got totally wailed on, my shields, I had no shields, my armor was almost all gone, a couple more shots I would have been dead. It's like, drastically, this is on her, right? It's on her, playing on her. I'm drastically getting my armor, and my nanites and my armor going, I run back, run into the thing, grab some energy, turn around, and guys come in, I just start this intense fight, I use the laser, I use the grenade, Kiro comes on, incapacitate most people, she comes on and says, those nanites are awesome. Jump down after a huge fight, I grenade the shit out of Kirill and then go incapacitate him.
Nice.
It was actually kind of a good save. I didn't expect it. I was like, oh crap, I better survive. I haven't played in a while, I haven't played in a long time, so.
Interesting.
Everyone was laughing. It was like,
no gun in your hand, right? So of course I'm going to go in your hand.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I had a holster, but so you pick up a gun, then it'll...
He was there yesterday.
Hey, Turk Bunker. How's it going? This is my brother Steve. You guys don't know him. A creative lead also of Consortium. Writer of Consortium 1.
Yep.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. He wrote this book.
He's bringing out the book.
There's book. My favorite book. Great book. So this is kind of informal. We're just gonna play through, just chat, whatever comes up. You guys, any questions you want, go for it. We're just hanging out this morning. Hope everybody's having a good Saturday. Yeah, remember how many iterations this thing went through?
Just to wake up in general.
Yeah. Sick. I probably replayed that one moment probably like, I don't know, 1,000 times total. From the moment I first did it to when it was finished.
Much better. Not so sorry to wake you, Bishop. We thought you should know about
it. I'm very much looking forward to getting this all into Unreal 4. We have a section of it in Unreal 4 now. The mission ops is almost mostly converted. You guys will be seeing that later in the campaign.
We just met 2 hours.
But there's a lot more to go, and I'm excited about getting it all in.
It just looks a lot slicker, smoother.
Mm-hmm. It does look less slicker. More details, more crisps, less jagged edges, no more jagged, all the jagged shadows and whatnot, of course.
Okay. Someone's a little eager. So let's get you suited up and ready to kick some homeless ass. Here are your basic consortium tools.
Where do you find tome?
PCU, BUS, assault helmet.
I think we were all surprised when we actually printed out and saw, like, the books came. And it kind of like hit me. Oh my god, it's a book. Yeah, the amount of text in there.
Yes, I did. The group were up against
like
the
homeless
mercenary.
Yeah.
Just looking at the PDF going,
At that point, we were just desperately converting it all into the game. Just like a bit of process down. We were just furiously getting it all in. We didn't really get a sense of how big it really was. How many details are. It was funny, playing this yesterday, some of the guys who played our game multiple times through, didn't see the stuff I was stricken. They're like, I never saw that before. Well, the whole thing, you can follow her into the... I'll do that again, just for fun.
Spiders,
yeah.
Silk, Kevlar.
And trigger that conversation if you happen to be close to her.
Are you sure you're all right?
This conversation went through more iterations than almost any other conversation. Save for the Kirill. Kirill's big conversation.
Wait, this is actually Tree 2. You mean the Tree 1 and Tree 2?
This entire opening with her speaking to her. This changed a lot throughout.
It can go for a long time if you pick the right things. That's what's interesting. Ready to break heads.
Well, yippee-ki-yay, Mother Goddess.
Cliff Monkey, yeah. Or Chiff Monkey. Yes, we are.
No, well,
not
yeah.
The whole game.
No. We eventually will be porting game 1 to UE4, but we are actually, though, porting over all the mechanics, yes, and we're porting over the content of Zenlil, the entire plane. The very beginning of the tower will start off back in Zenlil again.
You know what? You're acting a little lopsided. Maybe you should go and see Rook.
This way you can see your continuation. All the stuff you did will be reflected in Zenlil. You'll be able to see your universe in full force, exactly as you left it. Zenlil will be exactly as you remember it, basically.
Right? We don't want a banged up bishop on our hands.
I do. Banged up bishop.
Pick
up the suit. Right. See, I didn't pick the suit yet. She's waiting to pick up the suit. Okay.
Now,
good.
Horn 7 and I have some CCU maintenance to take care of in the lower crawl.
The one thing I didn't go into was the information console yesterday.
Or maybe hit up the virtual.
Get out of the way! Come on!
Future bishop training scenario.
Get.
Down the hall next to the elevator.
Double punch.
Oh, and don't forget to go to the you can find your mission operations at the end of the hall to your right.
Exactly, Chipmunk. Yes, Zenlil is very iconic. Zenlil. Speaking of which, a lot of articles, as mentioned, on the front lines.
Looking forward to redoing this second one, making it a little more user-friendly.
Yeah. I think this stuff will be also, all this stuff will also all be available anytime. You don't have to go to up to a physical thing in the world. You're part of the HUD system, yeah.
Makes sense.
Definitely easier to navigate. They get closer to like a little automatic internet that sort of automatically zooms in on useful information as things are happening.
All the stuff will still be archived. But...
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you could go to the archives and do searches like this. You could bring up this old mechanism. I think some people have enjoyed that. Some people have gone in and like spent 10... one person said he started the game and then went to the information console and then spent 10 hours just reading stuff in the information console. Never even left the bishop's room until he read everything he could at the information console.
I hope he ended up liking the game.
I think so.
I read it for 10 hours and then the game.
I think so.
Stuff.
I think he's one of the guys that said like, you know, play Consortium is like stepping into another world or something. Which is really awesome praise. Stuff they're really proud of. We go pretty darn far into the world building side of things. That's for sure. Okay, so I missed following her, obviously.
She's gone. What percentage
she's
actually
in there.
Sees that?
I don't know, that's a good question. It's hard.
Yeah.
I wish we had more metrics hooked up to stuff like that, because there's no way for us to know unless we ask people.
Very true.
I suppose the information console could be considered fun, unless you're like me and have already read everything on it 20 times over. Maybe try talking to Rook 9 in the cockpit. That's always an adventure.
Facebook notifications. Oh, you guys can see them, okay. Yeah.
Just the game.
Yeah.
Anyway, if you don't mind, I have to go check in with Rook 9 now.
She's an awesome character.
Hey,
yes. And she's an awesome actress.
Try to avoid Pawn 1 if you want to keep from screaming at
me. I feel really bad. If you jettison her out, like when I even recorded the footage for the trailer, we're jettisoning her out of the airlock over there,
so,
I felt bad.
Oh,
Bishop!
She's screaming.
Yeah. So nasty. You can really be grade A, real nasty guy in this game. Certain times.
Please, just call it a CMC. Hearing consortium mind communicator.
Our philosophy has always been like to create the most believable simulation we can.
Consortium officers only need to think what we'd like.
In
to
the case
say
of the tower, the rules are all different because
yes.
It's not a tiny little contained environment full of people.
Sir.
So kind of
yeah,
real fundamentally different.
Okay, Six. Before you move on to something else. I wanted you to officially meet Rook 9, Captain
I
of Zen.
Well, if there's anything
glad
else I can
glad
help,
to have
you
here with
you
us.
Let me know.
And
of
that
course.
Is actually why.
Thank you,
just
sir.
There's ways pretty good at the simultaneous CMC talking trick as well. K-15 is not the only one I can do it.
She can just hold full conversations.
Yeah.
Where do you think Pawn?
And her facial expressions too. She's able to like she was fully gesturing to Kiro the whole time. As far as Kiro's concerned, she wasn't discussing the CMC at all. So she's a master of that.
Yeah, I have
those. Ooh, spoilers? Crift Monkey, you didn't know? Okay, so in Zenlo 2, last half of the game, when you're fighting the traitor, this door, all these doors can be blasted open, right? You have the ability to grenade all of them if you want to. So,
or the bad guys can grenade them, technically.
Yeah, that can happen accidentally.
That doesn't happen very often.
She lobs grenades at you, so if any of her grenades are near the doors, you can get blasted up. That's the one one time I died that way. She was blasting a whole pile of grenades. I was next to a door. I got sucked out. I died, which is kind of cool. So there's, you know, but anyway, she's sitting right there, right? And she says some kind of thing like, get him, Bishop, or something like that. But you can just like go bam, 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 and then she'll just get sucked out of her chair and
she's screaming
for her life.
Really miss having
it's really nice.
Wade, just stop right there, please. He's only kidding, Six. Or at least he better be.
So, hey, all kidding aside, give me just a few minutes to finish up this diagnostic, and I'd like to get a look at you.
We added that because of the Kickstarter.
For now, I want you to walk around
the Kickstarter stretch goal.
That's right. Enhanced simulation, yes.
Exactly. I wish we had more time and money to create the aftermath of that.
Oh my god, that'd
react
be cool.
To the fact
you know, there's
that
like
you just blew that door
dozens of things we could have done if we had more time and money.
You caused that.
Time and money is everything to make how good of a game you can. So it all comes down to shipping a game at all is a real painful process. There's always dozens of ideas. You just gotta go, oh, it's not quite finished yet. I gotta cut it. Like, for instance, the king forcing the player out of the out of Zenlo, right?
Oh, yeah, we had a whole
we had
for that.
That
well,
in the game for the longest time. It was all in there. Essentially, there was no way. If you took too much time to go and get your gear and talk to the people and then go and jump out of Zenlo, the king would come on and he'd basically take over you. You'd become like a zombie for a while. You'd like, lose consciousness.
And you'd wake up. I guess you'd wake up with the doors open.
Yeah, wake up with the doors open. You're right in front of it, and he's like, jump, bishop. And if you ignore that, he'll put you out again, and then he'll forcibly jump you out, kick you off. That was so buggy, and it was so broken, and we were so close to what we needed to ship the game. I had to cut that stuff.
Narratively, unfortunately, because it would have been a nice. nod to the other side,
mm-hmm.
the fact that he's able to do that.
Yep.
He really wanted to do that for that reason, to say that the king could physically control you.
Yeah, it introduces some interesting gray elements that
plays into
that does fit
what
into
they believe.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that would have done a nice touch to the story.
That looked like it hurt. Use utility energy to power your medical nano. Select the number two and back in the utility suit.
Imagine we were testing the game, playing the game 50 times, and still coming across stuff that we've never heard or character lines. I heard that from the studio.
I can still, yeah, exactly. I can still play the game right now and hear lines I've never heard since the studio. Just the way the conversation trees work. It's not about pumping someone out of all their information. It's like, if I triggered everything that person can say, okay, moving on, I've used this person enough. That's, most RPGs do that. And scenes, yeah. Hidden scenes. But because so much stuff is attached to conversations, usually the conversations are what triggers the scenes, or vice versa. That's what's going to be so awesome about the tower, is that you know that you think this big environment with a bunch of guys you can shoot, that it's just, hey, it's a shooter. You walk around, you shoot stuff, woohoo! And you can play it that way. It's going to be crazy when you see all these systems here are in play. So you can just run around talking to everybody and stir up a big storm. And the political situation is so charged that the story is going to be in play whether you want it to be or not. You'll be forced through these series of events just by the nature of the context alone. Exactly the same way Consortium 1 works story-wise, and yet it's on the tower. It's just going to be awesome.
Just with more factions.
Yeah, more factions and more complicated stuff of like, what is really happening here? It's, no one's going to really know for sure. Right until the bloody end.
Now incapacitate.
Most people do this. Oh my god, this gun sucks! It doesn't do anything! Even though it kinda does, you can slowly see your stamina going down. But it doesn't take much to knock him out.
After bringing your enemies down, get up close and stick them with nanites to incapacitate them.
Yep, you can often take down somebody that doesn't have shields.
Notice that you can inject multiple targets simultaneously.
These are tools. These aren't weapons. These are Consortium Bishop tools to do their job.
The Kingdom of or CAR, is your alternate combat weapon choice. And
the civilians.
It does not
Hello.
Need utility energy to function, and instead requires physical ammunition. The kinetic assault weapon, or CAR,
I don't know. Who did the voice of the civilians? I don't remember.
It was literally we more or less tacked it on the recording session.
Yeah, one of the actors.
Yeah.
That's right. But like, hey, you can do civilian. Because we're going to do a bunch of stuff to the sound anyways. And it's kind of worked out. He made these funny lines, and we're like, hey, this is kind of funny. I think he ad-libbed a few of them, too.
Oh, yeah. We had a lot more, too, that we ended up not putting in.
Oh, no, a civilian died. That guy's just obliterated. One of the interesting things is that it's really dangerous. Just like real life, if you get guys with big guns coming at civilians, they die quickly. So, hence, it's kind of unforgiving in that regard.
You're done. Good luck out there.
We didn't have that line in there for the longest time, which sounds sad, I know. That's it. You're done. Good luck out there. The end. Her ending. It ended with text on the screen saying you're finished, but some people didn't read it, didn't pick up on it, or whatever, and didn't realize that it was over. So we had to add that line in. It's like, wow, obviously it should have been there from the beginning. Get out of here.
I always just skip that.
Yeah, me too. Somebody yesterday didn't know that they could skip things too.
Connected to that, yeah.
Hmm.
Where?
Typo. Scenario. Yeah.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, there. I see.
It's a spelling error in that. That's retarded.
Not sure what a scenario
I'm not sure how that made
is.
It in there. I really don't know actually how that's still in there. It's bizarro. Okay, well, watch that to be fixed at 1.26. Yay. It's going to take me weeks to fix that bug, though, guys. To track down that typo. I don't know.
Seriously, how did that?
I don't know. I really don't
You'll
know.
You'll see most of
it's
us
trippy.
Doing it.
But, you don't play, I, every time I play this game, I swear it's trippy for me too. Sometimes it just does weird things.
With our
it's kind of spooky.
Interact with numerous systems.
You don't have the same sort of access with yours, but you do use your hands.
The good find, either way.
Like it even
you play it a million times and just stop looking at the text on the screen, I think. You just don't even
yeah, I do.
Mm-hmm. We can talk
but
more later.
You just the first
maybe after Angela stops.
Sometimes
like
coming back to it for
yes,
a long time, you see
home.
A lot of fresh stuff. Mm-hmm. Oh god, there's that bug. I'm just gonna walk away and pretend I never saw that. Yep.
Well,
I don't understand why that happens. Actually, you know what? Since I'm here, I'm just gonna damn well look at it. This happens very rarely. I do not know what she's standing on.
Good afternoon.
How she's standing on it. It makes no sense.
She's typing at the keyboard. She's
I know she is.
Here.
No, she's pretending she's there, actually. She's holding onto the railing there.
Okay,
and she's working at that server.
She's turned this way and flying. Okay.
Yeah! I've attempted to track down why this happens. I don't even know what circumstances cause it to occur. I think it may have something to do with the virtual trainer. You going to the virtual trainer at a particular time because it switches levels, and then she's doing something on her rounds, and that causes it to blurt when you come back out.
What if she's there when you come out, and then she's pausing, and then when she comes out, she's
but why? She's just an encrypted sequence. She's locked in place. This is the same stuff she used all throughout the rest of the game for countless other things. It makes no sense. Some of the mysteries, man. Some of the mysteries. At least it doesn't happen all that often. I've played many times and not seen it, so. That makes it harder to debug, too.
You know it as well as I do, Patricia.
That turbulence thing
now.
Is pretty funny.
She could come back from the call.
That wasn't in there for the longest time. That was one of the enhanced
like
simulation goals,
move.
Yeah. That's what I'm really hoping we'll be able to hit by the end of the campaign, the expanded simulation goal, because that's this sort of stuff. Stuff that's polished stuff to enhance the coolness of the simulation.
You've only been here a month, and you're already complaining.
The nanites can do more cooler things. When you get closer to them, they can have more animations and particles associated with them. They can buzz, they can go in the actual direction,
but
you know,
I'm
based on
push me
spoiler story stuff.
Yes,
in dangerous spill of territory. Sort of. The nanites are more than just things with building tower. They actually are part of the story, too. Yeah. Gotta let her lead before
good
he'll talk to us.
Bishop. I'm sorry you had to hear all that. There's always a choice, Bishop. The good Lord saw fit to give us the gift of choice, and you chose the consortium.
This being the same
your
actress that did K-15.
Your choices as a bishop will in turn affect countless lives. Are you
yes.
sure
girl.
You're
she's an amazing
for
actress. She really channeled two different people so brilliantly.
Well, if we're both still alive
she really
liked
doing crazy
32.
When she snapped.
Careful, you're giving me I guess everybody here has played
Consortium
1.
Yeah, I assume so.
If you're watching spoiler alert for Consortium 1.
Other than babysit
yeah.
pawns 4 and 7, on a regular day...
You're a little crazy for even attempting to make the Consortium game. You might be right about that, Chipmunky.
Where were you when we started making it?
You should have let us know to begin with. This is crazy, guys. Just stay away.
I'm sorry, Bishop, but
I must admit, I think both of us are addicted to a challenge.
Wade mentioned something about environmental monitors acting.
But you know what?
And he wants
as ambitious and crazy sounding as the tower sounds, it's amazing how much we're building upon what we've already accomplished, right? I'm not sure I'd ever want to go through the consortium, like the three-year production nightmare that it was again. We're making up so much stuff along as we're going. It's bewildering. Now we're just copying ourselves with a bunch of stuff, and then adding a whole bunch of new cool stuff. It's a lot more fun and simple.
All in the same
framework. Oh, a lot more fun.
What's
that?
All in the same framework.
Yeah, exactly.
The frame is what took forever in the first
Yes. Unequivocally, it was the most dangerous thing. It was the most riskiest thing. We were making it up as we go along. The story itself took shape because of how we were making the storytelling tools. It was all just one big blur. It was like, that's not a very efficient way to approach things. Now we're able to focus purely on the story. Knowing our system that we're using to tell it, that's just going to be awesome.
And from a writing perspective, all the main characters, that took iterations to get them down to. Now they write themselves.
Yeah.
The core five, they write themselves. They're easy.
Bishop,
which helps a lot.
Right. You can almost channel the characters now, right?
I was only doing
enough backstory, enough stuff
maybe
in my head now.
Yeah. So
scene, go, okay.
Right. So we all the cool events that are happening in our story, you could put them in those situations,
exactly.
And then they just say all these things, and then the actors go, yeah, I know this, and they just dive in there. And,
find
come
it.
On,
you only have one official washroom to use, Bishop. One. And
this
the
is one of my favorite conversations.
Currently broken,
it
plus
is.
We often have up to
and then it goes off into La La Land with Jeremy Soule, right?
The whole thing is bizarre. It's really fun.
I went through that yesterday. I went through the whole conversation. The Jeremy Soule thing yesterday. It's just the fourth
yes.
wall.
We were in the studio while we were doing this whole
shelter
scene and doing the lines,
and
she just kept laughing and laughing. Like, I can't believe you guys are doing this.
Well,
this is great, but
like,
you know, what are you doing? She loved it.
Sounds practical.
If you say so. Maybe I should tell you what happens to the waste after it's processed by their suits. That would surely make your skin crawl.
Do it.
Drinking water. A small percentage is made into drinking water for the soldier, and the rest is disintegrated. Anyway, this has been a uniquely twisted conversation. Perhaps next time we could talk about the weather.
So I recently someone mentioned that this was their favorite character. Good old Charlie.
Oh, well, hey,
on the forum?
Yeah.
No, they meant 12.
To talk if you want.
Oh, are you sure?
Yes. I read that.
Oh, okay.
He asked me to iterate. Oh, no, I meant 12. Yeah, I've never heard anyone call
I was happy that someone said this guy's favorite character.
Yeah, that's, yeah,
I thought
yeah,
so, too.
Well,
I like him, but
I mean,
I've never seen him as a favorite.
What's that you just said about your skin? Oh, well, that's not really very nice. There's a lot in life I don't understand.
This is our...
Women, cars, algebra, exercise, women. I'm sure
training.
I'd understand whatever you've got going on. I'm a good listener, really, I am.
Oh, yeah.
100%.
Oh,
yeah.
Bishop, I didn't
right.
hear you come in.
Good call.
I have to get back to work.
Get back to work, then.
Wait a second, Makai, not so fast. Are you coming to the party or not? We're having it before you leave for home, the second we're done in BC. No excuses will be accepted.
No, I can't.
So
I'm sorry.
Happy.
It's nice to meet you.
We're putting up his interface, getting to work. You'll find crew members walking around using interfaces or walking around. Like us walking around with cell phones.
Bishop Six, welcome to the medical bay.
This place is disastrous.
The best in the world.
I'm Bishop.
Of course, Canadian.
That's right. Had to throw our Canadian nods in there where we could.
It was a QD.
Yep.
A movie bishop. It's all he ever does. Watches movies and makes me do all the work.
I should be
this
saying,
is untrue,
I should be
bishop.
Saying all that when I'm picking
we
tonight.
Have equal tasks to adhere to,
right.
According to strict consortium
protocol.
It's
interesting to watch, I think. I think everybody's done this before.
It was a joke, boss. You
as
know I
was.
Love you.
Ooh, say nothing.
Joke. Right, of course it was.
Ah, that
well,
joke thing, you only
you
get that if you say nothing in that one spot.
Said you seemed a little mixed up.
Some of the say nothings are actually
if
just
step away
pretty good ones. Just generic
scan.
Throwaway lines.
Best to be sure.
Some of them actually
totally.
Continue the conversation too.
Yeah, and some of them are appropriate in that moment. It's like an actual, that's like the correct choice or whatever.
Don't be afraid, Bishop. It's perfectly normal.
This will just take a few seconds.
Don't be such a wuss. How is that even possible?
I'm not entirely sure. Bishop, you have more simultaneous synapses firing than it should be possible. It's as if there are two of you.
Hello, Devourer,
mistress. The same brain.
Two?
Hi, Devourer, mistress.
It's the
Twitch. Make any sense.
Why is it notifying you, notifying you late? That's
anomaly?
So weird.
Yes. Unless the bishop has an explanation for us.
If our mistress, your best guess is to look at our next broad. I make posts on the page to say when we're going live. So far, we've never been late. So, if you want to, I would. If you really want to make sure you don't miss the stream, I would just be there at the date we say we're going to be there. And we'll be there.
If he has never seen it before, then it is undoubtedly very rare.
Whatever this is.
But point is, it's still
should. Like
people have just joined here. This is my brother
yeah,
Steve.
Yeah,
this you guys know me by
we're
now.
We're
but
we
here. Both share the creative lead responsibilities for the storytelling and world
I
building of Consortium
back.
Universe.
If there's nothing else to need, Bishop.
Yeah.
Yes, it is a fantastic VR game.
He's 10 years younger than
right
me. Youngest, my, young, young, my youngest brother.
Military commanders.
Leather
it's a distasteful and disrespectful
years?
Game, especially in these times. It is also only played by a small number of people.
Hmm. why would you call it disrespectful?
Exactly. Why? People need to wake up and realize that the resource wars are over.
You're generalizing again, 24. And Bishop, I simply believe that most people have seen enough death and destruction for a lifetime or more. They do not need to be reminded of it with advertisements for murder simulators all over the newswire and VR servers.
A good day.
He's running out of breath for that
really
line.
Nice
VR servers!
I've been keeping online on our two fiber escorts outside, hoping they break the silence and speak to Angelov. Well, one of them.
How many of you guys went through the first time you played, open up all the containers in here, and then go proceed to destroy every single item?
What books are in there?
Right. Ah! That's a new Earth.
They're all real books, man.
This is Rise of the Global Newswire.
Yeah.
That's not real. Amen, The Awakening. Is that a real book? I want to read it.
Yes, it is.
The Drawing of the Three, Stephen King. Evidence of Guardian Influence. Was that by Bob Schmuck?
The books that are mentioned in there, too, that are story-related, are actually, you can read about them in the info console. They're mentioned in the info console. So they're
no worries, DeVirus. Awesome to see you here. Really cool to see you. Welcome, everybody, and all. Game about the Resource Wars. That would be interesting to write, too, and to come up with what happened there, yeah. The world basically transformed from how it is to we recognize it today to a world with a completely different economy, fundamentally. After a lot of death and destruction. The Resource Wars, a feud of futility, speaking of which. The Secret History of the LDS. That's
so that's a whole game in itself. Have a Pawn 1 game. Play as Pawn 1. That'd be awesome. Pawn 1's battle against
living
the LDS.
Living life and feeling good. Yeah.
That'd be awesome. That'd be a fun game.
Pawn 64's locker locked. That's permanently locked, isn't it? You can never get into his locker.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And Pawn 4's locker locked. These two lockers remain locked. Of course, yeah, we're tricky this way.
You can have that open in second game.
What's that?
You can maybe have that open in the second game. Have a way to open it. Get into 64's locker.
64? Oh, in the beginning of the tower. Yeah! That's a cool idea. Yep.
But now it's just because he's paranoid.
Yeah.
So he locks it.
How many of you guys go in here and start playing with the clothes washer? It's really fun. I just do this for hours sometimes. Just open the clothes.
Gameplay.
Gameplay, correct. Actually, it's funny. I actually did some thinking behind how this would work. That you put the clothes in, it does a washing cycle, a drying cycle, and then the clothes get dropped in here, all folded and looking nice and spiffy. You pull them out. It's like this, yeah.
There's something in there.
Yeah.
why don't washer dryers do that normally? How come that's not a thing? Right,
I know
now?
It's going to be a thing. It makes sense.
Why doesn't it just?
I always tried to think of, like, is there a way to make this more science fiction-y? Is there a way to push it beyond what we have today? There's all kinds of cool stuff we had working with this big crane system. We even had it so that these doors here. Oops, that hurt. These doors open up, and then one of these things gets put into place. Drape, the crane flies over, this thing slides across the center, turns upside down and drops it out. I have all that working. We really got to make use of that somehow. Make a promo video or something where we show all that stuff working.
I can see that.
Yeah.
I can see, like, you can still do the idea of having K-15 do a walk around. That could be a good video. You're just walking around the ship with K-15.
Oh, yeah. We still have that line.
You go into that room and it has
yes.
It happening. You could have that.
Oh, that's awesome. That's there you go. There you go. That's a really good idea. We've already got her line saying that whole thing. You are Consortium Bishop 6.
Cool background stuff just to show that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Mama. Look, we need to say goodbye now. No. Don't tell me to shut my mouth. No, Mum. You need to rest. Yes,
right.
Ian.
Hey, Ian.
We'll talk later tonight.
The XYZ, yeah, that stuff's nasty.
Goodbye, Mum.
Nasty. We've worked out how the XYZ works, too.
Welcome to the nerve center of everything.
Years ago, we worked that out.
You see all those buttons and switches all over the place? I actually know.
True nightmare weapon.
Every one of them. How's that for impressive?
Very. Oh, which very?
Oh, Christ, I wish I was being serious.
Scotch!
It's not like this plane doesn't fly itself anyway. A drunk captain wouldn't make much of a difference.
That was one thing. that we
added, thought of the more options. Yeah.
No, we wanted to add an actual liquor bottle in the cabin somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Why not?
Like, at the start of the game, we must have a few winners. For every hour I stay awake, I'll give myself
a bottle of Macallan or something.
8 pounds later, and I'm still doing pretty good.
Oban.
Do you have any closed spots, closed spaces?
Oban,
yeah.
During your missions, I'll be the one guiding your hand, telling you where to go and what.
Wait, wrong way to the tower.
Pretty much
nice.
Into any security system.
I wonder how you'd appreciate that.
He's already got a girlfriend. Yeah.
So, B, is there anything else you need? I've got something here I need to concentrate on. Good. If that changes, you know where I am. And hey, welcome to the Consortium.
XYZ is explained in the info console.
Oh, no, that's
the chemical one on this.
Right.
Does
it go into describing how it works, everything?
There's one where they're talking about having found a stockpile in the North Pole, and I think it describes what it does in there.
And,
I believe.
I understand. Aimlessly in such hard work at all. Don't want to stress you out.
Stammer and then
well,
steal his
if life. You're up for it, I'd appreciate it.
That's a good idea.
Right across from yours. Okay,
work that in the story, Steve. Go.
Done. Authority. Yours are clicking.
CMC is jacked into your head. Didn't anyone tell you anything? Us Brooks and the boss. Yeah, everywhere you go. Except when you go to the bathroom, of course. There's an automated privacy setting.
How the music gets all dark here.
Dome.
Hell, wait, lock down that cabin immediately.
Way ahead of you, boss.
Is that Pawn 7?
Sometimes we got really clever with the voice acting.
2 minutes ago, what happened?
Sometimes the story of how this whole cabin sequence ended up in its final state. I had problems, obviously, the people going in, and then the doors open,
yes,
and then
sir.
You could trigger it, and then run outside, and the door would close, you'd be stuck outside, and things
I'm
like that.
Sorry, Six, but I need you there, at least until Book 13 can take
it
over.
Eventually, it ended up in its current state, the way it works, how the door immediately shuts down. There's no way to, once you turn the lights on, there's no way to leave the room. You're stuck in the room, and it's airtight now. So we had the voice acting, we tweaked the line so that it helped make the whole thing smooth and worked. I think Steve just naturally did it. But it's cool how the dialogue it works deeply in sequence with what's happening, what's being triggered in the game, what's going on in the game.
I sure can, mate. You just watch me.
Just take it easy. Let Rook 13.
Only because a lot of the
we'll
things that happen in the game, the triggers and the doors opening and closing, things like that, a lot of it comes from the story. It comes from the screenplay directly. So Steve's counting on it happening when it, you know, at the right times.
A general idea how Hammer worked in my head when I was writing nice pieces of this.
Hammer meaning the game editor. How the game editor worked. Which Unreal Forge is all that way more. Nothing's gonna stop us in terms of, you know, what the story needs to do. The game, we can have a game.
Right. In such a bitch term lately.
Way less than with Source. Yeah. Especially with his. The environment of the tower is designed. The Unreal 4 engine is designed for environments exactly like what we're building.
I know what that means,
like,
you know.
From
and
the
that's
ground
really
up.
Disrespectful. So how about you just shut up?
It looks as though someone threw his head against a locker panel.
First person, big, sprawling, complex levels.
That's keep on going.
As a matter of fact, this engine, the Source engine is kind of too, more than it is for this ship.
This
engine is not at all designed for this small, confined space. Yeah, this is a classic example of making a game with an engine that wasn't designed to make that kind of game. We just did it, regardless. With the tower, that goes away. We're making a game that the engine was designed to make, in many respects. With, you know, some custom stuff, of course, but...
Is that some kind of joke? My book.
What was that, Kira?
This is a very complicated
your
animation.
Book?
It's the most complicated animation in the whole game.
What your book was doing under
all
the dead body of one of my pawns.
Jason
Zayas
is one of Jason
Zayas'
coolest contributions to this project.
I noticed it was missing from the med bay this morning. I simply assumed someone had borrowed it. I was apparently correct.
Don't be juvenile, Six. Nobody goes in the brig until
get in
you
the
know
damn
for sure they belong there. Now, Alana, I hear your concern, but we can't risk someone seeing you move his body to the med bay. I'm sorry, but forget
red
about the
red shirt found lying in his own blood.
All of you, listen to me very carefully. This stays between us. I swear that we'll get to the truth when we land.
I wonder if fellow concerned plus Tita Lana, if you managed to raise her level
really
high enough to positive
side.
To have her having a crush on the bishop, you mean, Devar?
That's
funny.
I want to know who. If only so I can personally string
I do think that's going to be fun, actually. We will need to figure out, you know, the height, we are going to figure out and work out the specifics of how the characters will react to being on extremely high or extremely low alignment. That's fun.
Yeah, like what they are at the end of the first game. The second game will start
capital
with
punishment
that.
Isn't exactly
yeah, they'll probably, matter of fact, when you first meet those people again, they'll be like, oh, hi, Bishop, and she'll be in whatever mood, you know, based on your alignment. She'll be, hey, fuckhead. Or like, or, hey, how's it going, Bishop? You're awesome. Yay.
I think it'll be more obvious the differences right at the start of the game
as
opposed to first game. You don't see the differences that close.
Totally. Yeah.
Consistently as they should be.
Hopefully, everything will remind you of the way you left it, right? Will the tower contain essential scenes like this? Good question. Chaos is good. Ian, that is a good answer to the question, actually. Yeah, there'll be essential beats, probably. But the thing is, they may be different based on what you did previously. If the question is, do you mean there's going to be, no matter what, everybody's going to see a scene, it's going to be exactly the same? Hopefully fewer of those than in this game. Hopefully there'll be some differences, right? I think Consortium storytelling is a lot about subtle differences, you know? And I think we'll be doing way more of those things, because they're really cool and they're easy to do. It's just Steve and the writing team writing it in a certain way to say, you know, if this the only thing that's
keeping
a lot of
mind everything that's happening.
Yeah, you can, because you spray it down to something like the person either says this line or this line or this line. Three possible lines that could be said in this juncture, right? Mm-hmm. Each of which could dramatically be carrying on three different storylines in that moment. In terms of even the writing team could have different threads going on and they could just weave it to the screenplay. And we just convert that and suddenly so many layers going on. But it's all just in how the screenplay is crafted. Crafting the screenplay is a fundamental part of production and defining the game we're making here.
Still not
like a movie.
Exactly like a movie.
Six and Kieran.
That's what's exciting. We're actually able to do that.
Great Bulgarian nuisance.
Very exciting.
He's on the holocom now and he's acting well. You'll have to come see for yourselves.
And the reason why it's production for us is because of the fact that it's never been done before. I'll be actively scoping the game and doing a lot of the core work.
I'm only trying to
with the screenplay. It's a fundamental part.
Again.
For the third game, it would be done in pre-production. Once we're 100% positive, we can make the game that way.
I hope
we'll have the confidence going into game three, so we can have all the stuff taken care of from pre-production, and the production could be way grander. We have a really big vision in mind for game three, so we could be able to handle a lot more content and be much bigger
you
game.
You are funny. I think I'm going to like you.
Enough posturing. Either tell me what you want or get out of our way.
You have no idea what is happening here. Poor little girl. Your king must be blind.
Did we not just go through this song and dance a month ago?
Yeah, it's
and
cool that she's been pushing the boundaries
you
of
spanking for it.
How high you can get
my
down.
Father will
you can get
not
up to plus 70
to your rescue.
The high 70s.
Come now, Carol. It's Christmas. How about you let us pass and we'll get into this another time? I promise. How does next Tuesday look for you?
Listen very carefully. You will land and surrender your warship immediately.
Yes.
If you do not, I will blow you out of the sky.
I take credit for that line.
Give me a minute to
I remember specifically editing this part. I'm like, have him say, I want to blow you out of the sky. He's like, okay, Greg.
Okay, Greg.
Can you please inform local authorities of our location?
I just wanted to hear him say that.
Yeah.
He said it, and it was
quite
cool.
Quite a few lines in a row, and I go, I just want to hear him say this. He's saying it. That's one of the things about Angelov, is the only character that what I wrote was usually twice as long as what we ended up keeping. He's the only character, because I just like to babble with him.
It's
just so much fun to write. Angelov in general. So you remember that? We would record these big, long lines, and we ended up just scaling them back.
He'd go on these soliloquies, for freak's sake, sometimes, right?
Just go off.
Stupid, but also irrational and hot-headed. A nasty combination for someone in his position of power. It's very deceiving.
So in the tower, I perceive things, a long conversation like this, you'd be able to interrupt. Because in the tower, you'll be able to speak whenever you want to. Situation like this, you'd be able to say, or get people's attention, or excuse me, or things like that. you'll be able to just say, and then in that conversation we'll have like a break point where if a player is trying to interrupt, then it would break to, hey, we're having a conversation here, or screw off, or something like that, right?
Pay attention, or
shut up and pay attention. Yeah, exactly. Like, Bishop, do your job, come on, why don't you contribute to the conversation here, or whatever.
You give him far too much credit.
So I look forward to that. It's just building upon this system, really.
Thank you, Bishop. Decay does have a point. But
the mentality
we can do is wait and see
doing
what
everything
he does
we can
next.
To give the player
now, let's see
things
if
they
I
can
can't
do and things that people will react
to.
And yes,
keep stressing that.
Chief Monkey, exactly. Watching basically now a cutscene of these three people saying exactly the same thing every single time over and over again is frustrating for your players. I completely agree. There needs to be more variability. There needs to be more the ability to control things even more, and to be able to, as a player, to be able to affect things on a quicker basis, more often than we were able to allow you to do in this game.
I've detected two new incoming
F-35s. We had an in-game idea for being able to skip lines. It was actually going to be one of our stretch goals in the original Kickstarter.
7 kilometers off of
that's right. That's right.
Going ahead in time, we were going to have like a fast forward button, so the whole system would run in fast forward mode. So you could stand in the middle of mission operations and hit this fast forward button, and everyone would just run around like crazy. And eventually, someone would walk up to you and go, "Why are you just standing there for like an hour?" which would work for conversations. You could just hit fast forward and it would just skip through conversations, done.
And it'd probably be like a hot button where you just hit it and it automatically speeds up time to the end of that conversation for you.
It works in game. We can't just have a skip line system.
But that's Gavin Abbott. Remember Gavin Abbott? Gavin? That's Gavin.
I vaguely know Gavin when I was like 4. Hi, Gavin.
Old friend from way, way back.
Yeah, source code,
definitely.
Good times.
I can't see a bloody thing, boss.
Guys?
Not a bloody thing.
Guys, you may want to... Oh, shite! Get down!
Doctor's on the ball. So do we save him or not? He's on his team. Oh, Steve's to let him die. Let's just watch him die.
Is everyone all right back here?
We've got 2 down and a room riddled with bullet holes. What the hell just happened?
I'm sorry. No bullet in existence can penetrate them.
Correct.
It just doesn't make any sense.
Just relax.
She's got nothing to do because her console went down.
Now, tell me
he's
going
to check the mon for 25 underneath, trying to fix the console.
Here in his name is Gary Mon. And Bishop, get your damn
ship wide failures, our weapons, primary engines, cargo.
This whole scene worked out remarkably well in the end. All there are so many pieces we're juggling to make this timing of this one work.
Back online, and I'd also like to be able to
shoot
the back
gazillion iterations.
The placement is
so
easy.
Yes.
Just do the best you can, and do it fast.
Exactly.
Yes.
Something else I would have rather any kind of HD remake of this game, I would totally do it this time. The one thing I would have it so that is when the engines suddenly get hit by the MP, the whole plane should have lurched downwards and start barreling towards the ground. And then the new turbine comes in and slowly the whole thing levels out. That's actually what would have occurred, but that
would just
be on scope.
Flying
everybody would like, it'd be nasty. But it'd be super intense and awesome. And I think we could do that with Unreal 4, for instance. I mean, any kind of HD remake, we could do that.
Let's hope it won't be necessary.
That'd be fun to do one year.
All right. Let's hear what he has to say for himself.
Yeah.
Now are you prepared to surrender?
Yeah, there you go.
Drop the ridiculous act, for God's sake. This is not like you, Carol. You just shot up 2 of my people with that little stuff.
Smug look at his face.
Even for a second that you're going to get away with that, you have another thing coming.
Tell me something. How does the Covenant tell?
It's completely
dictator's grip around your throat.
I think I can.
And she's finished fixing the console now. She's getting up from underneath the console.
Have you completely lost your mind? If you destroy this vessel, you will only bring the full might of the Consortium down on you.
I'd say it's pretty simple. We stall long enough to fix our guns, and then we flip his arse back to mercenary oblivion.
Oh, she's actually gesturing for that.
Enough time.
Drawn to enjoy your company.
Let him use the boarding carrier.
Excuse me. Say that again, Kieran.
We let him use the carrier. When he boards, we simply separate the head from the snake.
He's actually thinking that line.
And
see him kick that line.
Kieran has a point. You claim to be a politically driven mercenary whose worst crime before today was raiding some cargo flights and kidnapping a little politician or two. You are small time, Angelov. All of this madness today is far beyond your threat level.
Threat level. You can
Little nice touch from Travis there. Spitting on the side.
I was going to ask the same question.
Now is not the time. Remind me later and I'll tell you.
Right.
So Amiga's mistake is one, and the rest
like when you've got
hijacked
running, what was it? 5 tons of black market ex-gon materials from Berlin.
Cockpit's still kind of messed up.
Those murderous Syrian and Iraqi mercenary groups chasing you, they sure didn't like you being in their airspace.
Yeah, chaos. The, Kirill's dialogue there, that's
that
probably the most iterated
familiar
conversation in the entire game. This whole bit between her and him, and we rewrote this over and over again.
I'm sorry,
Kirill. Over and over,
really?
Over and over again. Scaling it down.
This technically, Kirill was the very first guy we ever had say a line with our system. The very, very first test of a character saying a line was with the early version of Kirill. Different model, even.
It's the first actor we had.
Yeah.
He was working with us when we
Darren,
were. Darren's the rest of the characters were voiced by us.
That's right.
And Darren came
we did a whole pat. There's a version of the game that has all of us voicing the characters, actually.
If you'll only listen to me for 2 minutes,
early,
I think I have a solution.
Alpha build.
Do your crew a favor and stop speaking. Let the men talk.
No, no, they have not. No. Not in this game, they have not.
May I speak to you for a moment?
You can sort of figure it out a little bit in the information console, but it's definitely something we'll get into in the second game.
A bishop with some kick. Very nice. I'm sure Alane is just clawing at your belt buckle by now. Is she not?
I heard someone else use that line in the chat recently. Someone clawing at their belt buckle. That's such an evocative line. You see someone clawing at a belt buckle. Desperate. Desperate.
You must be feeling a little
well. Keep him talking, sir.
Kirill's my bro. Especially to keep his end of the deal with his steakhouse request, or whatever it was.
That's right.
Nice.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice. So have a whole scene where you can sit down with Kirill in the steakhouse.
Nice
game.
Sounds like a nice game
three.
It does,
actually.
A nice tie-off to Kirill.
It does. If you kept Kirill alive.
Yes.
And then you befriended him. Yeah.
You're just chilling out.
What was it like finding Bond 7's body?
That would actually be a fun scene. Just eating dinner with Kirill. That's it. Sitting at the table.
Yeah. It's a futuristic cafe around you. Futuristic steakhouse around you, rather. Yeah.
Why don't you have someone take
listen
to
other people's conversations. Everybody around you having deep conversations.
Do not look to her for permission. Look at me.
It's okay.
Devour Mistress. She's the one that mentioned it. Okay. Climb with the belt buckle.
It'll only take a minute.
You will not leave this room.
Well, there's a dead body lying here.
Now, and put them on the loudspeaker.
It's an animated dead body. There's a zombie here.
Why are you calling me Patricia? We have a bit of a situation up here. Please don't ask me any questions. Can you just do me a huge favor and go look inside Bishop Hazel's cabin? Get back to me on this line ASAP and don't come to the shop.
Sure, of course. Give me just a few minutes.
Wade, go ahead and unlock the cabin for her.
It's done.
All right, Kirill. Now that you've stirred
the turbulence animation didn't make them all do
the
same.
Surfer's
like,
Go away.
You were just
that could have used a bit more polish.
That was another Kickstarter, right? That was, of course, that was the same stuff.
Expand simulation, yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Not yet, Bishop. Soon I will give you that chance, but not yet. Excellent decision, and I'll get to that in a minute. Now, about Bond 7. Camera.
What's his lament to us? I'm guessing it's positive. Positive 6, yeah.
Those who hired me have managed to install.
Mr. Off.
Minus 5. Minus 2, Elena. Charlie, minus 1, interesting.
To keep that dip going.
In your vessel.
Okay.
I can see it in every room.
Tell me he's making that out.
He is.
Yes, I'll play the nasty anti-consortium
boss.
Asshole.
It's impossible.
No one?
Yes.
Okay.
Kill pawns and try and murder all 3 pawns too when you get a chance.
Okay. Book says, we want to make him your friends. Okay, so.
You are smarter than you look. We both know it would be impossible to install such equipment on that vessel.
So the conversation is
instead
long,
of simply
long,
denying
potentially
it,
long.
You played along.
We're very sure.
Interesting tactic, but it does not answer how I know about the dead pawn, does it?
Keep it up, Six. You're doing great.
Pawn 19, come in.
I'm here. Did you find anything?
There's blood everywhere.
He's headed. I get out.
Cool thing about that is the character doing a good performance.
Is dead. My God, you people are like children.
That is really not necessary.
I will decide what is necessary. Now, Bishop, you impressed me before when you called my bluff. Impress me again and tell me, if not cameras, then how do I really know about it?
Gotta play the game at least twice to fully understand what we made. Anybody that plays through it once quickly thinks it is not just simply, unfortunately, hasn't really played the game. So that sounds weird, but most games, the idea of getting it and just finishing it in general is rare for many people, right? So many games these days, how many of us start a game and never actually get to the end, right? With Consortium, it's just a whole different paradigm. It's like, think you get to the end, that's, yeah.
I admittedly get very confused. Maybe Alana. Reviews and stuff say, I beat it in 2 hours. I don't know how that's possible.
I can speed run the game
maybe,
in 2 hours.
I tried speed running. When we were bug testing towards the end, I think it was 2.5, maybe 3 hours.
Yeah.
That was my speed running.
Like, yeah.
If you are naturally playing it and you do it in 2 hours, you must have skipped 70% of the game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Systems are not very reliable.
You're saying nothing to everybody. I don't feel like talking, right? Which is fine.
And avoid all other.
And ignore everything else and just like go, I'm looking for content, all I see is an airplane, this is annoying. If you play the game expecting a regular video game, you're just thinking, no.
Part of the issue too is I think anybody's
people on their phones,
they see mission objectives, they do their mission objectives. That's like any game in existence. You see a mission objective, you do a mission objective.
Yeah, exactly.
But if you do that, you'll skip a lot.
Yeah.
Kind of a weird thing. Anyway, it's just this.
Our game just welcomes you to do things outside of the standard treadmill, video game treadmill.
Rook 13,
video game treadmill.
He came on board almost immediately following Bishop 8's so-called retirement. I hear that Alana pushed the transfer through. Perhaps she is involved as well.
27 hours playtime.
I doubt it.
It's a good number
she
of hours.
Far too highly of herself.
Ian, see you soon, man. Hey, we got a team gathering happening today. Safe travels. See you soon.
Only 27. I think that's pretty solid.
Yeah, that's a good number of hours.
Awesome. We've seen a good chunk of the game.
And while I have no choice but to kill you, I choose to let them live. Once you are dead, I hope your people can discover this traitor and move on.
What do you actually do in No Man's Sky to the point where it's basically a meme? Yeah. What reminds you of that, Chip Monkey? I've been following that game with interest. Curious to actually boot it up myself, run around. The developer themselves speaks to their game very strangely. It's probably one of the reasons why there's less confusion.
Such honesty in the face of death. I'm mildly impressed. And I have to admit.
I don't know if I got here. 12, there we go. Good. It's healthy.
Enough!
71 hours. Yeah.
Awesome.
That's awesome. But I'll still bet you there's at least one thing you haven't seen. I'll still call it.
Yep.
Probably one thing. One scene, one conversation, one something.
Yep.
Well, listen to what I have to say. What's it going to be?
I was hoping I could make you this angry. Something about English women with authority in their voice. It makes me tingle all over.
Make your
decision. Oh, the idea of objectives and win states. Right, exactly. Players are invested in knowing, having the game lead them through the game, piece by piece, bit by bit. Exactly.
We just refuse to do.
Well, except that we kind of do. Unfortunately, we do give into that thing, right? There is the mission information, primary objective, secondary objective, shtick.
Well, yeah.
We don't always use it, though. But
it's in-game. We're not railing.
It's true.
It's true.
This is in-game. Yeah. Arrows and ground. Go this way. Big arrow. Ding, ding, ding.
Yeah. We do get a lot of people saying...
I am not about to hand you my bishop on a bloody platter.
I could just tell my men to open fire on
people
you.
People get
right
very confused
now.
By it. Unless you run around. Since that second playthrough, you're fine, but
will you
first playthrough, you're a little lost, I think. It's a big plane.
is funny because it's actually a very small game environment.
Oh yeah, overall. Yeah.
Disarmed. But it's a big plane. It's all scaled, so it feels like a big plane. So you can get lost like you would as
so
if you really were a human exploring a big plane. It's just.
I will give you 5 minutes to do
it's a relatively small game environment, but it's a large set.
5 minutes, and I want you off that ship.
Wade, will you please prepare mission part one? Set it for autopilot towards island, and we'll pick it up when we're done.
Kirill and Net 15 sexy time.
Already standing by.
They'll handle
it
with enough jump from the cargo containment unit to simulate combined weight.
Fan fiction,
write
that.
Someone go write that. Someone go write that now. Post it on the forum. We'll tweet about it.
Scan for life signs. Okay.
We could, you know what's funny about that is a game would allow if someone were to actually write something like that, we could almost put that in the information console of the second game. Seriously, someone in the world knows about this interaction between K-15 and then decided to write a fan fiction in-game. There's no reason why there wouldn't be actual fan fiction in their world of all bishops and what's already been done. It'd be actually pretty funny
to
write.
We do have ourselves an emergency weapon.
Indeed. Come on, get around his body. You can do it. Thank you.
In there, you'll find a couple weapons
hurry,
to choose
up.
From.
They're positioning that carrier just behind our tail.
Damn, he's impatient. Okay, launch mission pod one now.
Mission pod one is away, and it looks like two of them are following it. That sound, ladies and gentlemen, is the sound of a boarding carrier tearing a hole through our hull.
It's showtime. Just remember, Six, disarm
yes.
and surrender to his men. When Kirill comes aboard to gloat, that is when you arm up.
Hey, here, I have something I want to talk to you about. He's hinting. It's actually a little hint, a little foreboding, the fact that he's gonna bring you aside after all this stuff goes down.
You can take a few of them in there, can't you? Some of them have lines to fit them.
Yes, it's too late now. Yes, indeed it is. So what do we do here, Steve? Am I getting into a combat, or am I... How about
immediately? That is better.
How about we go all the way down and then open up combat? And we
sir,
sure.
We have the bishop and he appears to be surrendering.
Yeah.
Excellent. Hold your position. I'm on my way. If he so much as sneezes in your direction, you know what to do.
Fanfiction.net.
Yes, sir.
Someone's gonna make a consortium section.
We're just not.
The game just simply is not as popular as Mario, Sonic, Mass Effect, or Deus Ex just yet.
Sonic fanfiction, oh my god.
Shut your filthy mouth or I'll shut it for you.
Pretty sure that's his plan.
Don't do it.
Pretend
Bishop.
And then
don't
slaughter.
Push me.
Who?
You heard what Angelo said.
Sermon surrender.
I'm not afraid.
Oh, Angelo, you mean?
Kirill Angelov is a great
man. Oh, so I see.
Returning Bulgaria to its former glory. His father may have fallen for consortium charms like the rest of the world. All of you puny ants falling into place for the new world order. I have served under
Angelov.
It's fun
having the other guy be this guy's brother.
He's
the same actor.
You would be smart not to enter him. He is far more intelligent than he appears.
The best lore I've ever seen in a game. Thank you, Chipmunky. That's cool.
Don't you
wouldn't say it's a shame. I'd say that's just the reality of the fact that those games have gigantic corporations behind them with the engines, the ability to have something be known by the masses. You know, we're a couple of independent game developers made this game for fun out of passion. It's not a it wasn't a corporate creation by any stretch of the imagination. Ah, crap. Forgot that
energy.
All right, Six. Do whatever it takes to get to my bottom
set?
Julie K-15 sexy fanfic with half-dressed Alana and
Oh my goodness. It's getting raunchy fast, folks. This was a nightmare of all epic proportions. This whole thing, the guys, the fact that you
did good.
Yeah, I prefer to not look down there.
I need you to come back to mission operations.
Some ideas were very complicated to actually implement. And hindsight, more than it was worth.
Alright, people, I think we've only got a minute or two before our friends out there start playing not so nice.
And our weapons are now, Bishop. You've got work to do.
Let's see what the Bishop can do.
Before he heads for the guns, I've got an idea. Can you patch me into the F-35?
Hey, Bishop.
No problem. You're on.
Pilots are threatening homeless mercenaries. I am Knight 15, commanding officer of the Consortium vessel, Zenlil. In an effort to seize control of this vessel, your leader has been captured by our bishop.
Pontrol
is going to have convenient jail time.
One of the more interesting overall arcs and character arcs.
Where your family members live.
Coming up.
Oh, him? Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, poor guy.
I'm only going to do it because it's spoiler spoilers.
I was just going to say poor guy.
Disengage immediately.
He's such an innocent soul.
He is. It's true.
Wait. Do me a favor and fire a couple of shots across a few of their bows. Give them a little scare.
You've got it. A few already tacking off, boss. And listen to this.
There's no hope here. Angela has betrayed us. They're not disabled and they're too powerful. We must retreat.
The rest not running off for home are beginning attack patterns. It looks like we've got ourselves a good old-fashioned dogfight. Bishop, I need your other guns right away.
You can access the manual weapon system through the command interface inside mission operations.
I should have killed Kirill so we get the super hard version of the minigame. I haven't played that in a while.
All right, so this is Zen's manual weapons control interface. Now let's get this thing done. Quick crash course before I let you at it. You left control and lock and release non-lethal EMP tip missiles.
It's true.
And press and hold to lock onto your target.
I wish I had a fanboy like Pontrol.
The missile will fire
on
the target
and
swat your target from the sky. Your right control is end point defense laser. It's most useful for destroying incoming missiles. That bad boy can also obliterate fighters in an instant.
You know, we have to actually
pilot.
Have him get you copy.
So
like,
try not to.
We have to close that loop.
Finally gets to the coffee.
Finally gets it. That's it.
As he says something like, the night's not around, Bishop. Here's a coffee. Here's some coffee.
He sneaks it.
Come on, bring it on. That's too easy. It's still too easy. But.
Option is MacMartin 12. Yeah, that's, you know. Be a good, good idea. I think he deserves a good smack sometimes.
And trying to get it on purpose. I honestly, the least favorite aspect of Consortium 1 is the minigame. I don't much like it.
You definitely killed more of them than I would have, but hey. Considering the spot we were in,
I would have far rather have the whole fight be experienced from inside Zenlil. Somehow helping Wade.
Bishop, eh? Could have done that without taking a single hit.
From inside Zenlil. Still being
to do it on his first day. And six, now that everyone knows, I want you to start an internal investigation into the murder of Port 7.
That's cool.
Seven.
I think it actually would make a fun little a mobile game, for sure. The actual, just as a game design itself, kind of cool. But yeah, fighters are just flying around going, shoot me, shoot me, shoot me. I agree, that's not realistic fighter flying behavior.
That's true.
Yeah.
It was one of our biggest problems when the game was first released, too, though.
Yeah, it was.
We redo that over and over.
It was, well, the difficulty was really quite intense, and people were
it was hard for us
playing
to gauge
this one game.
Difficulty. What's hard for us versus what's
hard
for new people? We're like, oh,
yeah.
I have no idea.
Because
it was easy as shit
and,
for us. We're still getting people saying, this is really, really
well,
hard.
It was made difficult because of the variability of it changing inside game, right? You could have it be extremely hard if you killed Hero.
Yeah. And it gives you no time to practice. There's no practice.
Yeah,
it's
no,
just you have to listen to what he's saying, otherwise, oh my God.
Yeah, you're tossed right into it, yeah, into the fire.
A couple of factors there.
Okay, so we're Sentinel 2. So these two just get out of their things. Let's talk about these guys.
Exactly, Consmon. I think that's exactly what Greg was saying, right? He wished we did a version where you're in the cockpit doing stuff, much more in-gaming.
Yes. Okay, so she goes down and makes out with Wade. He goes to the bathroom. How many of you guys have followed him to the bathroom and then listened to him and go to the bathroom?
You got a second?
Of course, Kendra. Come in.
They got some stuff to do. Boom!
He just went running at her.
Yep.
So I hear Knight 15 wants you asking around about Matt's so-called murder. Are you here to grill me?
Yes, I am. So did you do it?
What? Don't be ridiculous. That's barely worth responding to. I suppose you think I also sabotaged Zenlil?
Should be a yes! You do seem pretty nervous.
Of course I'm nervous. You just asked me if I committed murder and betrayed my own crew. How did you think I'd respond? I don't appreciate where this is going.
Here's one thing I forgot to do. Changing the name of the broadcast.
I'm sorry. I guess I'm just a little worked up. Not every day is like this. I can promise you that.
What is it?
Nothing responds. Where?
Go into a little room and punch a kicky shoot like that one Babylon 5 movie. Not sure Babylon 5 movie you speak of, but I am a fan of Babylon 5.
This is too much. I'm pretty sure it's getting worse. Well, if it is a virus, and I think that it is.
Again, we have situations where it is more reactive and in situations where it's not. It's just we're talking hundreds and hundreds of them throughout the game. If every single one was unique, that would have just been madness.
He's a little stubborn sometimes when it comes to this ship. He refuses to admit it could be an invasive virus messing everything up, but he's been in the cockpit all day. Hey, maybe you could talk to him. Strength in numbers. Not to mention you're a bishop and I'm just his poor
She reminds me, the girl from Archer.
I'm no exception.
The chick from Archer, the crazy chick.
Oh, yeah.
She sounds a lot like her. Every time I hear her voice now, I always hear the girl from Archer.
I'm not going to let you eavesdropping.
Okay, and Wade's hilarious response sometimes. Pun one talks. Shit, you just walk away from him? Yeah. You're not my supervisor.
Those are separate, too. The walk away is, the say nothing. They all have unique lines.
I'm sure Pun 51 will be a little longer at the least.
Second game should be a little more reactive to certain things like that. I think we'd cool that way. Walk away.
Talk.
Cheryl, right? That's who it is, right?
That's
Archer.
Yeah.
Archer's a one hell of a wacky show, I tell you. She's crazy. No boundaries.
This season is actually really solid. I wasn't a big fan of the last season, but so far it's really awesome this season. Very funny again.
Coffee, really? Thank you.
Yes,
sure.
Please.
Coffee in a Saturday morning. What are we doing here? Okay. Murder mystery.
Oh,
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, not a chance. You get the hell away from me.
Stop it. Go away. People actually did this. The percentage would be nice to figure out. Knowing you can keep clicking.
What don't you understand?
Yeah. And one of our team members, in the early days, it was just, you know, playing our game and stuff, early days, he said he did this maybe twice and then didn't think there's anything and walked away. Never triggered this whole thing. Never solved the murder mystery.
That's what you're still pestering me about.
Potentially the only situation where you can keep pestering somebody, essentially. Keep clicking on them and they keep speaking. So it's supposed to
I really wanted the Blue Jays to win the World Series again.
I agree, I like it. It's part of the whole, you know,
but that never
solve
happened,
a mystery. You gotta, like, poke through every corner.
And now they're gone.
Look under every, you know, look under cranny.
That's life.
I love Jen's voice actor. Jen Skogan, yeah. I think he's Steve's favorite.
He's my favorite character.
Character, yeah.
Definitely. I've been
here all day.
He's the only one that was not voiced in
Vancouver. We don't know anything.
We did all his
lines.
He did all his own lines
in
the studio at his own house.
Right.
He did all of
this
stuff over email, believe it or not. I did voice chatted with him once throughout production. It was all email, back and forth, discussing each line,
that
figuring out how to make them all work.
Amazing.
He would record them all multiple times, too.
It
was so much fun.
Gold star! I truly hope you're satisfied because I'm done
just
talking.
Such a dick.
I don't use the P word
so good at being
that
a
often,
dick.
But will you please leave me alone now?
Farewell, my lovely. I wonder what it was like for authors in 1940.
Turns you right after.
Farewell, my lovely. You should pick it up sometime. You know, when you're not investigating this murder.
That's an awesome Travis work there.
You don't know what you're doing, do you?
Yeah. Solarian Embassy formula request. You stop touching her. Who wants spoilers for the traitor? Conspawn, you haven't played this game yet?
I'm only saying if you haven't played it yet.
Has anybody here not played Consortium?
Assuming if you're here, you've probably played it. But
we were talking about this earlier. We thought we were both okay with spoiling the traitor, because we assumed that anybody who's watching the stream has already played the first game. But enable gaming for good so we can donate with Bitcoin. Oh, I like gaming for good, actually. That's a really cool idea. I will look into that. And we're still new to this Twitch thing, but we're big supporters of gaming for good. Yeah.
Uh-oh, and we started playing.
So some of you don't know who the traitor is that right? I'm going to just sit here until you answer that question. Do we spoil the traitor or not?
We can just not do the traitor storyline. Yeah.
Someone who does not want it to be spoiled, speak now. Or it will be spoiled.
This is spoiler.
This is spoiler city, right? This whole stream is spoiler city, yeah.
In fact, I think we're putting us in a room together and putting a camera on us. I'm a little worried that we're going to give away crap for, like, the second game. Things just start.
We've come close a couple
out.
Times.
Exactly.
Come close a couple times. About to go, spoiler!
Stop talking!
Like, yesterday, someone asked about the darkness in the tower. What was that?
Oh,
creature.
Yeah.
The darkness creature.
The darkness, that works. It's the darkness.
And someone said, so it's like Lost, right? I'm like, yeah, you're not the first person that's compared it to Lost. My answer was, this is a hard science fiction game. Everything has at the end has a scientific rationale for it.
Yeah,
he asked, is this game mystical? I'm like, well, sometimes it might feel mystical, but you can feel rest assured there is a scientific explanation.
And we will
at the end of it.
At
right,
some point.
Right.
All is explained.
Yeah, exactly. It won't be like Lost, like, oh yeah, no, darkness is just like the island. You get it? Don't you get it?
I love Lost.
Voting for spoiling it, Devourer says. She says, to spoil it. Nanomachine Sun. That's Ian says that. Where did you get that Nanomachine Sun from? Conspawn? Weird.
He's chatty, isn't he?
Yeah. Did he say that earlier, though? He's copying it. It's weird.
Was that the nanites or something?
Play this
else?
Section out and don't choose anyone. I see what you're saying. Okay. That's, yeah, all right. Conspot, can do that.
So, thanks for stopping Angelo and those mercs.
he was moving the little details of he uses his hand gestures to unlock his locker. Home 4 locker. Ooh, now unlocked. Beluga caviar.
Why not?
Poor belugas.
It's like one of the more expensive caviar they can get.
Yeah. Well, actually, not cool. That's just the fish eggs, right? Caviar, it's just the eggs or whatever. Ooh, pawn 32. Get those two riled up. They're both pointing fingers at each other.
Holy hell, you just don't listen, do you? Fine.
Found the book.
Well, you should be looking into what lies behind the pages. Now leave me alone.
I'm really very busy right now. Do you mind?
There's a little... some animation glitches in here. This whole place is very complicated. The whole thing of having her on that... working away on that thing and being able to get on and off and stuff and talking to her has got proved to be a little more complicated than I wanted it to be.
Sure, Bishop. What can I do for you?
Why did you... No. You've been together all day?
Look, I don't exactly have time for this right now.
Just double checking.
I'm sorry. It has been a stressful day, to say the least.
You bitch. Call them off my sister. The bishop knows what you did to Matthew. How you cracked his skull open and then smiled as he died at your feet. Admit it! Tell the bishop what you did!
What is your problem for? I don't... Oh, wait. I see now. If you accuse me, then there's no way to prove you wrong, is that it? We were together all day. It sure would get you out of being investigated, wouldn't it?
Don't listen to her, Bishop. She's poison. I followed her into Bishop Eight's old cabin and found her.
It's true, Devour. Could have
standing
bad, Greg.
Over
what?
His body. She,
could have talked to 32 before you went to the locker.
That's a lie.
Oh, yeah.
Both of you, shut up.
Could have, would have, should have. Can either of you prove?
I can't believe this. You're just going to believe her because nobody likes me? This is bullshit!
Route 25, control your people.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's enough. I have a big enough headache as it is, and neither of you can prove a damn thing. So drop it. You can squabble and bitch to the investigators in Ireland.
Anna, please, you can't just ignore this.
Oh, I'm not. If you want to stay,
well, you gotta keep in mind, it's not really a lead, it's pawn 4. Pawn 4 pointing a finger doesn't really mean much to other characters, I think.
Her stuff.
It's just...
Look for a...
Although he is pretty convincing.
Bomb
he
or
does,
something?
He comes off pretty obviously.
Forget
he's being very legit.
I'm done with you people.
Thank you.
Don't thank me yet. I'm not entirely ruling him out. Get back to work!
The thing is, the one thing that keep in mind is that the idea of there being a traitor is completely unknown. They're all everybody's kind of shell shocked with the whole idea. So some of them are definite denial that there could be somebody among them that's not truly consortium and bound by the consortium mandate. Just the idea of that is just like absolute heresy.
Sorry,
the bewildering, because the king has been so perfect in choosing everybody just right for the job. The idea of him being wrong in any way, shape, or form in itself is bizarre.
There's
so, yeah.
No immediate rush. Whenever you're able.
If you're here to question my people, wait for them to finish. If you're here to question me, do it later.
Question us? Come now, Bishop. There is really no need. And you are qualified for this?
It doesn't really matter, does it? Hold first, then you can chit-chat until hell freezes over.
Well, no. Hold first, chit-chat later.
I'm Bishop.
We could really use some help around here with all of these repairs. Let me know when you have a minute.
We've almost got them all. Just take it easy.
I think in a forum somewhere recently, sort of someone wished that there was more upon 11 interactions, and I agree with that. The French poem.
It seems makes you nervous.
A little more with her would have been nice. I'm looking forward to getting back in her. She's a great actress. She's a great character. Much more could be done.
Because I didn't have anything to do with that. I was a mission up the whole time. Ask anyone. Really.
Definitely.
Anyone
she
at
die?
All.
Maybe we should sedate him.
She
no,
one of the ones that can die?
Bad Kieran. Just take it easy, okay? Nobody is accusing anyone of anything.
Yeah, the one of the ones because those, by definition, they'll have less of a presence in the same game.
Thanks for coming to see me.
Guaranteed.
I'm just, you know, getting these huge fragments taken out of me. The doc here says those experimental bullets should have blown me to bits. It didn't hurt at all. No, not one bit. Not at all. Nope. No. No, sirree. No. Have you ever been
twice? Let's actually trigger the
there's two big
other. Let's trigger the other big conversation with her. I didn't bring up Jeremy Soule, did I last time? Damn it! I did it in yesterday's game. It's a different game. Okay. There's so many threads. Bewildering. The big conversation you can have with her if you talked about Jeremy Soule earlier. Keep pushing that.
So, are you here to help or just wandering aimlessly?
Yeah, so there's three then, I guess.
That's about
three
right.
Big ones. One's based
it
on
shouldn't
Jeremy
take
Soule.
Long. What do you say?
I know, of course, the big one with the whole about the murderer thing, right? With Pawn 64 walking up and stuff. You could
it's
you could
your
do that
call.
Now.
We're quite used to a bishop with no interest in Zenmil and her crew. We'll make it work. I'd use a different adjective, but that works. When he wasn't on a mission, he could be found by himself in his cabin or flirting with anyone who'd listen.
You're just like
no,
him.
No, you don't, Bishop. He only survived as long as he did due to blind and dumb luck. He sort of had an uncanny ability to see things coming that none of us could, and it saved his life 1,000 times over.
Killed 5 people, if not counting the traitor, Kirill and Killsman, right.
Yes, Bishop, he kicked ass.
How to die.
Bloody Rambos. Well, whatever. If you come around and feel like being helpful, let me know. I'll do too. I want this done by the time I get back.
Oh no, that was.
In other words,
of course.
I want you
that's the pawn just got fixed in the med bay. He's
elsewhere.
He's all fixed up and he's heading back to his base. That's cool.
Well,
no. That's a good example because I went in there and triggered that whole sting in there. That triggered the him being finished eventually. Gets and then he goes back to work. Did I miss all that last part?
Since we killed pawn one.
So Bishop, I hear you embarrassed poor pawn 11 here. That must have been something to see, was it?
Right,
I'm sure it was. I really have no doubt.
Are you done? Why do I even speak to you?
Yeah. Technically, you're the one who's causing him to die.
Why is mum the word? What do you mean?
It's an old saying, Adele. It means he won't speak about you embarrassing yourself. It looks like our new bishop here is a gentleman.
Hold on a second. I think we're about finished here.
Yep, just one more. Bingo! And that, as they say, is all she wrote.
All who wrote?
He's gonna just drop
them. Never mind. I think we did good work here.
Yeah.
Rook 9 should be happier than a wirehead on Black Friday.
Yes, well done.
Known thing, this actually was a weapon that got cut.
I suppose, like, now
we had a handgun in the game at one point, and we cut it, but we decided to use it for these things
Rook
instead.
25 did say you've been tasked to speak with us, yes?
Yeah.
Wait, you don't actually believe one of us is some kind of killer? It's impossible! I'm still in the camp that Rook 13 is wrong! There's no other reasonable explanation.
I have a hard time thinking that Mr. Excon Procedure is ever wrong about anything. It is not us you want to look at anyway. Try Pawn 64. If I had to choose someone, it is him.
Wait a second, you don't know that. He is a friend of mine, and I know he could never do it. Never. No way, not a chance. I know people, Adele, and I know you're wrong.
Maybe
Pawn
64?
Yeah, of course, 64 can be blown up. That's right. He either
so
dies
going
in the,
rather
you know,
not talk about
dies,
it. It doesn't make him a
dies
killer.
In the room, or he gets blown up.
I'm not accusing anyone, but he has been acting unusual. Distant, abrasive.
He shakes his head all sad.
Maybe Pawn 64 doing something he should not have been doing.
She's talking about him, of course.
But maybe he was contacting Angelo.
Adele.
No, Charlie. Listen to me. This is important.
Do you remember how you thought the bishop embarrassed you in the brig earlier?
You truly don't know when to stop with the jokes, do you?
Well, if you just turn around right now, you can discover what real embarrassment feels like.
Oh, Mel.
Hi.
Go ahead. Wait, yeah?
Just a quick glance straight to the thing.
I'm on it. Well, duty calls. Did I get that one right?
Some awesome work with Travis
duty
here.
Duty calls.
The facial expressions and the gestures and stuff.
And yeah, I should
spot
probably
on.
Get back to work as well. Lots to do.
Take care, Bishop. And watch your back.
Don't let her bother you. She's all right.
She's all right.
She thinks I killed Pawn 7 and helped Angela. She is not all right.
Nobody actually believes that. Don't be ridiculous. She was just blowing off some steam, releasing some of that tension we're all feeling today.
I know you don't believe it, my friend. And I understand I haven't been myself lately. But I promise you, nothing to lie. Okay?
This way.
Hey, Six, are you ready to meet with the Queen? Here, hang on one moment. Oh, and be forewarned, she doesn't like it when you waste her time. So choose your words carefully.
You never figured that one out, eh? Why she spins so slowly?
Yeah, it's one of the mystery that we looked at briefly. We never got the abundance of it, so just listen. Yeah.
The King has been particularly adamant about you.
Queen
and
of the Consortium.
He sends his regards and his regrets for not being here.
Hexadecimal actress. She's awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. You're so lucky to land her the role of the queen.
You know,
couldn't be a more perfect.
Well, I fit into the consortium.
Couldn't be a better voice for that.
Waste anyone's time with inane pleasantries. Bishop, I have 6 more meetings after this one, all before your induction ceremony in British Columbia. Now, I wanted to start by expressing my sincerest condolences over what happened to both Pawn 7 and Pawn 1.
44 and
they
11
were exemplary
like a
officers, and I know they will be missed by you and your crew.
44 and 11? Those
I
two?
Trust if a similar situation
yeah,
arises in the future, your bishop
will react.
Right. So, about Pawn 7, I wanted to...
Hold on. We'll get to that in a minute. So, Bishop 6... The King has managed to trace the takeoff point of Angela's boarding carrier to an airbase.
Well, the bishop underneath the suit would, I suppose,
King
have a uniform.
Yes, yes, the bishop does that. Yeah, there'd be that, like almost like a pajama-like skin under the BOS that similar uniform has. It's very unique. Same uniform, similar style as the ones you see with the rooks and the knight.
Someone would kill them and their families.
But each bishop would have a it's like a bishop shape, kind of how you can see there's actually like a bit of a knight shape to her.
About doing. Even this document could have been planted for the king to find. Kirill is no slouch.
They do with armor on, Chipmunky, but if they take all their armor off, they'll look like consortium officers with the uniform.
With him,
little known fact.
He wakes up. We need to know
so if you take it off, you're not running around naked.
Anything.
Right. Exactly, yeah.
Now that he's been beaten. Hell, he may even respect the bishop for beating him. But that's not important right now. What is important?
You think of the little things like that,
why?
And you go, imagine if we had endless budget, we could literally have it to take all
now?
Your clothes off
and
run around.
And
characters would just react to it. What are you doing, Bishop?
This was lost his mind. In the brig. Toss him in the brig.
So many offshoot things we could have done. Just weird things like that. Just some crazy player going
infinite
crazy
number
stuff.
Of things.
Exactly.
You know, you approach the idea of simulating a space like we're trying, then it's just an infinite number of ideas.
Let's hear it.
Possibilities.
I am a traveler for a parallel Earth.
Oh, boy. I want you to think real hard about what you say next.
I was just being silly.
Apology acknowledged. Now, do you have anything to say about why Kirill tried to kill you?
Streaking timeline. Yeah, that's right. Streaking! Bishop streaking!
Well, just imagine you walking out to Angela and you just pull your clothes off right in front of him. He would save you.
Oh, yeah. He likely knows I'm not really Bishop Six.
Damn it, Six! What is wrong with you?
I'm going to give you one chance to apologize for wasting our... actually, you know what? Just cut the crap on Night 15 and I will continue this meeting on a private CMC channel. Are we clear?
don't piss her off. I want to get to Night 18.
Okay, clear as can be.
Good. Now, Kirill, do you know why he did what he did? Or who could have hired him?
He's a greedy bastard. Wants to sell Zen Lo.
Yes,
Well, that's what we'd ordinarily think. But as Knight 15 pointed out in her initial report, the situation was anything but ordinary.
Incoming AV communication.
Acknowledged, not accepted, yes.
Who invited Reeds?
It wasn't me, I swear.
Good afternoon.
I'd never do that.
yes, 6. I was hoping to catch your attention for a moment. The light blesses my luck, it seems.
Colin, it's good to see you. I trust you've been through the
your new gods.
I have, yes.
Get to kill a guardian.
Mostly just
game.
Wanted to confirm that we're going in Ireland. The Stormbird moved in about an hour behind Zenlu.
Oh, that's funny.
And I heard Bishop 6 brought down Angelo. Bravo.
Bravo.
The ancestors must be keeping an eye on you.
Ireland is confirmed. We stop wasting the Queen's time.
He's another
very
one looking
good,
forward to
Bishop.
Bringing back Knight 18.
Quick learner,
yeah,
I'll
yeah.
give you that
I wish
punch.
We had more of him.
What was that?
Creepy.
Yeah, well, he'll play more of a role
in
the tower, right?
No, of course he will.
Yeah,
I wish he was more role in this.
Oh,
in the first
yeah,
game.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, if we had a conversation manager, for example, in the first game, he'd be all over.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no offense, Mum, but you've got other things to worry about.
This is true.
So, is that all you wanted, Weeks? We will be seeing you in a few hours, after all. Maybe you've got better things to do.
Why must everyone keep calling me by my last name? And just 1 minute. Bishop, that is such a dreary thing to call you. What is your real name again?
Well, you think the Guardians are other interdimensional travelers. I like that. That's a cool theory. Indeed. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Say,
there's no reason not to tell him your name.
I don't know why you would lie. Unless you truly do not know what your name is. But that would be absurd, wouldn't it?
This better be going somewhere, Weets.
Say your name. Say the real name. You can actually say it.
I know, but
I think if you say nothing. You might have to say something else and then say nothing.
You're the one that wrote it.
Yeah, I'm going to remember every single. I know.
Absolutely
it's in one of
absurd.
The
misdirect. But it is not that difficult a question. What is your name?
Weets, you are really trying my patience here.
Yeah, it is the first thing I think. But it's not all the same things. Try it.
You know what? Forget it. I think I have a name for you, and I believe that you heard this one
before. I guess it's the first say nothing, most likely. But
okay.
Can you hear
okay.
me? Hello?
Bishop.
You've been destined to fulfill by the Lords of Light.
And you cannot
save us all without first saving yourself from darkness.
I is very confused.
Interesting. First-rate Wheat's weirdness.
Vague
and why is my connection not affected by whatever just happened to his?
I've honestly stopped trying to figure out.
Hell yeah, yeah, that's a very strange
let's
choice.
Let's try and get this meeting finished before he comes back, shall we? Now, Bishop, last topic of the day, Pawn 7. I find it curious that the very
what did the
day
Queen and
K-15
see during that scene?
One of our most respected
well, they see these screens all flipping out.
Hours later.
So they hear static. They see the screens behind them. You notice the screen back here all went completely looey. They see all that. So they see the all the Zendel systems are going batlit for them. But the feed, obviously, it's not as bad as you. You change your entire feed. You know, the entire consciousness feed is being interfered with.
Oh, the Elia thing. Oh, jeez. That's right.
Yeah, where'd that come from?
The different, all the names. They're the. I forgot we did that. All the choices that
no,
you can pick,
no,
except for the real name,
uh-huh.
are names
your
CMC of.
Could confirm
oh,
that
it's been
already.
So long I've seen the series.
I
from
do,
Stargate.
However,
they're all names of characters in Stargate.
Great deal
huh.
of today's troubles.
Yeah.
And particular
years since I've seen that series, but a particular race that all the characters. That are named of that race are the character names that I picked for that conversation.
Huh.
I was big into Stargate when we wrote that.
Guess Bishop Six's name is well, yes, it is Bob. That's right, and you can find it, but we missed the. You have to. I think you have to say nothing after that to get the Bob option.
But the real way to find it and to find
that's
a little
cool,
bit more about
cool,
him,
Steve, I
totally me
that
or him,
nobody was forcing
the
information
you to stay. Console. You can
the
figure
king
a little
believe
more.
You cannot be involved
console.
With Pawn 7's death. Can
you
I
know more about who you are? I guess.
For now, right. So I will speak with the king about everything we've discussed. after which he can decide what our next move will be.
And I guess Angelov hints a little bit to it.
You and Wade
you.
Get that boat to Ireland.
What you were, what you did before.
We will.
You joined into the Bishop Six.
There's
right,
no
was before.
He's aware of the host past. The host, you have a host, he has a past. He's aware of that person's past.
We don't know whether or not Carol's was the only one of those cursed boarding carriers, and we're not taking any chances.
Excellent work. And
Devour,
I'm
yeah,
sure we'll be just fine. The Aether is a good ship.
Those are
it'll get us to BC in one piece.
But is his girlfriend dead?
Right.
For real.
Dun, dun, dun,
dun. Yeah, so most things, yeah, it's
I'm glad you're still here. It shows initiative.
It's also not his girlfriend.
You can leave now if you wish, but I was just curious if you'd like to ask me anything about what you saw. Maybe about the Queen, or Knight 18.
Mm-hmm.
No? Okay. I just thought I'd ask.
Okay.
Well,
offer. Like
we can talk some more later.
Alright then.
I've got some unfortunate calls to make, starting with Pawn 7's family. His mother and I go back quite a few years. We were friends during my university days.
See here, the early version of the
oh,
news system.
I'll have Wade
we're going to extend upon this for sure in the tower. So the
so
ongoing news events based on your choices in the game, right? So
yeah, this is missed by a lot of people, I think.
Pawn 1 killed by mercenaries.
Oh, bugger. She's really pissed off now.
Sort of spinning the story that he died
25.
Because of the sack, which is
why
true.
Why do you need to shut down
we
power to lower avionics immediately? She's got a mind of her.
There's key changes. The changes that you make. Things that happen in the world.
Come
yeah,
on, Route 9.
Yeah. Well, the planes
what
get...
The
fact that
you
captured Angela versus killing Angela.
Angela
being under fire.
The door is not responding.
Is this going back in time, basically?
Remotely.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Remote
yeah, sure
door controls are not functioning, and neither are maintenance access points.
Well, figure it out. Now!
What the hell?
That's
the
good to know,
that
Devour, that
the
wiki's being
itself.
Informative. That's awesome. I know
Six.
People have been working
that
on that. That's really awesome.
Enter
that's really
lower
cool.
From the
it's good to know that the deep story stuff is there and easy to find. That's good.
Super, super cool. I'm glad. It's awesome to me before you making that get it up to date if you need, if it was totally up to date. True Encyclopedia, all the lore that's been released.
My god!
All the canon.
Whoa, whoa! Stay back! It looks like it only gets worse as you approach him. Return to Milano. Tell us you have a brilliant plan to get Wade out.
I think so. I mean, it's going to be dangerous, but I could
spend
the bishop to the U.S. to attract rather than...
We don't need details. Just do it.
Watch your murderers.
Okay, it's done. Be damned careful, Bishop. Your BUS will now attract every electrical current in that room. Let's try this again, Six.
Okay.
And take it
slowly. You're going to get mad at us. This is the kill everybody route. Remember, we killed Pawn 1.
That's
and
right.
Kill all the
that's right. I forgot about that. Okay.
I just
all right, I haven't done this in a long time.
Where 64 dies.
So let's just not go
cool
back down.
Part.
This should.
What are you doing, Six?
And there's one time in the entire game during that scene where a character says the F word. There is one F word in the entire script
right.
of the game.
Right. It's,
and,
yeah.
You know, R9 gets that.
What's
says that.
That's
when
Pawn
64
gets killed. Right.
Wait a second. I think it's.
R9 gets pissed.
Well, I would be damned. The door from the medbay has just opened itself. Are you seeing this, Kieran?
Yes.
Too late now, Godspawn.
And I can see
Roger. Just waited out.
Whatever was happening here, it must have stopped when the door opened.
Minor glitches.
Guys, go rescue Wade, goddammit. Right. Sorry, Godspawn, we decided to play the evil bishop.
There we go. I don't
know.
He's back, he's saved.
Well, that was fun.
Wade, are you alright? What happened
monsters.
In there?
Oh, my head is bloody well killing me. But I think I'm all right. Thanks to Kieran, anyway. I was just about finished with the repairs to our auto guns when the main battery started surging electricity.
Ooh. You should be able to see Wade come make his way back from the hangar there.
Someone is toying with us. Why did the system lock out remote access points and door locks only back in when Wade was about to die?
Then locked you out.
Oh, the virus.
Wade, I almost died?
According
funky
to the
stuff.
MDI, you are less than 2 minutes from death. I must insist that you remain in the medbay so I can repair the remaining damage. There's only so much the medical nanites can do.
Takes a while for him to officially. He's dirty. He's staying in there.
No, forget it, Kieran. I've got to get back to the cockpit and finish repairs.
Wade, doctor's orders.
Forget it. I won't be responsible for not having weapons if we get into another scrap.
Here's a good example of how Consortium officers are allowed to do their own thing, based on their own assessments. They never have to follow the superior officer's orders. There is a superior officer, and you're encouraged to, but you can always break it any time if you think it's best for the overall mission or whatever, for yourself or for the mission. Yourself and for the mission.
There's no telling he can handle it, so the rest trust.
His judgment. We trust his judgment. Stop. He can do that. Yeah. Yeah.
I have never even considered saying this before to you, but I think you're being an idiot. You're stressed, angry, and you don't want to believe what's right in front of you.
Idiot.
My first playthrough, I noticed the damage and backed out immediately. They got mad at me. He went down and they came back out and they got pissed. Yeah. What's wrong?
What are you doing?
Yeah. I think Wade.
Did we
best.
Just fly Zen Mill through a portal into Crazy Town? Just figure out this bloody virus and do it now.
Yes, sir. Consider it done.
I think he's pretty delayed
as
in terms
of
him coming
you,
back.
You may not want to mention this incident to anyone. We don't want to further scare the crew for no good reason.
He's holding back information from them was such a good idea last time.
Come on, Olana. Ease up.
No, it's fine. She's right. I admit that I should never have done that with Born 7. But this is different. They are already on edge, and I'd rather not have them start turning on each other. Just do what I say, Olana. Please.
You're the boss.
And he changes,
hey Bishop,
openly flirting with
I just
Olana.
To thank you for siding with me against the boss back there.
What is the F-bomb? I think if we're lucky, Coast Bomb, we're going to find it here. We're going to show you the F-bomb.
Maybe Born 19 was right after all. Maybe I am too close to this ship.
I have no doubt that's true.
I appreciate the honesty.
It's good to get R9 and negative too, I think that'll ensure to get the F-bomb going. He's 5.
I knew I'd be stubborn about the virus.
One does not
count to
me
looking
the other way.
Okay.
I feel so violated.
Okay, come on, wait.
Anyways, mate, I'll let you get back to it.
It might have been for purposes of debugging. He goes through his entire conversation chain before he starts
having
to. Yeah, like at this point. I bet you now he's walking back. Okay, Pond 64 is coming. Since we did all that work anyway, I want to see him. Now I'm committed to seeing him come back to me. Oh! There he is. Still kind of bust. His health is low, stamina is low. Not feeling good. Not feeling good at all.
Since you're here, Bishop, both Palm 1 and 7 were good men. I really wish you had gotten the chance to know them better. And for what it's worth, Palm 1's anger toward you was rather misguided. I think we all knew that.
Only because we let Palm 1 die.
And now he's a dead.
Yeah. Well, as
they both look sad, head down.
So I'm told the bishop here has been tasked with investigating Pond 7.
I don't know, Pond 1 was a dick.
I'm assuming you have some questions you'd like to ask us? Don't you, Bishop?
Really?
To you? He's probably very nice to them.
Let's
he just didn't like
ask
you at all.
Yeah.
He seemed like he could be a nice guy.
Actually.
I mean, he's kind of nice at the same afterwards. He's a little nice if you go talk to him.
He's
not
true.
Yeah.
He does. He does. Thank you. He thanks you for saving his life.
Still did.
You really don't want to know.
Once again, the suits. Twice you bring up the suits, the seeds where it sweets where. A little obsessed there.
Maybe you talked to him 25, Pawn 32, or Pawn 4. They were all working with Pawn 7 this morning in the hangar bay.
Okay, I'm done with this.
All right, well, come
okay,
on,
Bishop. Maybe you and I can play chess sometime. I am sorry, Bishop. I guess we can't talk any longer.
A couple of things.
She's
done
too.
Yeah. Cool thing is they actually play a chess game here. I don't know how many of you guys know that. But
I honestly have no idea. And please, take
your time.
Please
don't check me.
Yep. If he makes a move, he's going to move that rook. Thinking. Rook moves over. Her time to make a move.
It's funny though, when you're doing this in production, when you first looked at it, you came back to the team and you're like, you know, the act all so cocky when it's so obvious which one's going to win.
Yeah.
The way the game board's set up.
Yeah, looking at the game board. Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
It's
and
so
but,
cocky.
But it almost kind of works if you imagine their characters, right? That she's pretending to be all cocky even
exactly.
though she knows she's losing.
Because
she's a really nice person and she wants the other guy to feel
yeah.
good for winning a chess game. Finally. Yeah, it's a real chess game. Oh, it's even checked.
We can't play chess, unfortunately.
He's been checked. The rook checked the queen right here. And she's a hard decision for her to make. Real
so
hard.
So many pieces.
So hard. Out of check. Yeah, so Jason, it's another Jason Zayas and me collaboration. Where he set up all the animations, set up all the system, and then I went in there and just daisy chained it all together. And then I also interjected some conversation too. The two of them will have a little chat every now and then, the mid game. Yes, we were really obsessive about some of the details, I tell you. But interaction unsupported, yeah. Fortunately, yeah, the chess mini game was cut.
Create an entire AI to see the play.
Write our own chess AI just for fun.
Done.
Poor Wade. Okay, let's go. Let's go. He's just sitting there all sulky and hurting up.
Wait, Bishop, hold up. I have an urgent matter to discuss with you. Thank you.
Okay.
We are safe to talk now. For now, anyway. I took advantage of the problems we've been having, managed
Careful,
to hack our sensors and disrupt those in this room.
You help guide me then.
I'm really not sure where to start. I barely trust myself right now.
Just relax, start from the beginning.
Okay. I've been a pawn on this vessel for about 3 years now. And you can trust me when I say that I know these people, and I know them well. Lately, though, I've noticed... Well... Can I trust you, Bishop Six?
He actually thinks he can screen me? He's one hell of an engineer, but I'm bloody Rook Nine. Tell him you trust him, and let's hear what he has to say.
It's kind of interesting that certain characters...
What's the best way to be the play the dick here? Go away, none of your business,
no,
right?
No, 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 you know, he'll run away at this point. He'll literally go away before it even starts. You want to go dick mode after he dies. Just get it going until he dies.
So I'm saying we tell Rook Nine go away. This is none of your business.
Oh, I suppose
that's what I'm suggesting we do.
You want to piss off Rook Nine?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, it is,
yeah,
Bishop.
Yeah.
I know he thinks we'd have no reason to be watching your CMC while not on our mission, but he'd be wrong. Now tell him he can trust
yes,
you.
Yes, he is. God's fine.
Bishop,
very
can
much so.
I trust you.
I was going to say it is an interesting, very intentional that sometimes the characters just suddenly appear as if they've always been watching what you're doing. Like they're just sitting there always watching what you're doing. It's bizarre that they do that, but it makes sense.
Yes, you can trust me.
Watch me here today. I was doing a diagnostic on our communications a week ago. Routine, something I've done 1,000 times. I didn't think much of it then, but when Angelov showed up, well, I knew what I'd found was something, I don't know, more. One more thing. First, you have to promise me that you won't tell anyone else what I'm about to say. And I mean nobody.
Yeah,
that's the plan.
Not
yeah.
9, not even 15.
This isn't so funny anymore. I know 64 and he's a good man. Honest, down to earth.
Don't say the second one.
Yeah.
Okay, well, here goes. The records I found showed over 12 communications within the past month, all between the medical bay and an unlisted number in Bulgaria. At first I thought it was only a little odd. No other calls from the med bay went anywhere else except Pawn 24.
Passes
a
point of no return at this point.
And now? Well?
The moment he spreads that news, he's a dead man.
Keep him talking. It should only take me a moment to confirm what he said.
That's important information.
Thing wants to work, that is.
Says,
yeah, that's super key to the whole mystery of the entire story. Matter of fact, the entire trilogy, even.
There's two key pieces of info he gives you here that are quite important.
Of course, it's possible, but not easy. Someone like Rook Nine could have done it, though. That's partly why I never went to him with what I'd found. I was afraid of him. I'm still afraid of him.
This is really something else. It's pretty simple, Dave.
Ford is here.
If I was working with Angelov, then Angelov would have succeeded.
Yeah, who has his name on the bottom of the forum? I think one other person had that at one point.
Hmm? At the bottom of the forum. Oh, okay.
Most number of posts.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's probably true. Unfortunately, there is one more thing I need to tell you. Something that doesn't help Wade's innocence.
Thanks, V. Now let's hear what makes me look so guilty.
You know those experimental bullets Angelo hit us with? Well, during our last major repair, only 2 weeks back, I happened to notice...
Bullets.
Atmospheric stability failing. Evacuate this room immediately.
Uh-oh.
What the hell does that mean?
That's our medical bay point.
It's locked.
Zenith.
It shouldn't
That's
be locked. Why is it locked, Bishop? Yeah, I think it's the air. It's getting thinner.
Another Jason.
We've got a situation here, people.
Custom.
I can't access the atmosphere or security controls to the Bishop's cabin.
Someone open this bloody door!
Rook 25, I'm coming.
The
Hang
Foley
on.
With the
Wait,
hammering thing is particularly part of
there.
That, Jason.
I
you snuck that
to.
In there. That's actually triggered by the animation itself.
Form 32, report immediately to the Bishop's cabin.
And hurry up about it! I knew I shouldn't have done this. Shouldn't have opened my damn mouth. Rook 9, you son of a bitch, help us!
You need to relax.
Yeah, that's also something we added after launch. At first, the helmet it didn't hurt you. Well, took it off.
You
and then we added
that.
Thank you.
That's great.
Obvious addition.
All yeah. the air you need.
Wait, oh, I couldn't. I'm out of room. Still full.
What are you trying to do?
Take the helmet off. There we go. Ow.
Very slowly.
Yeah.
Not unless you both want to die. You'd have to not only share your helmet, but your BUS as well. The helmet activates and uses a built-in air supply.
Does that mean I'm going to suffocate if you don't share it? What are they
Good
saying
point.
On your CMC?
Oops.
Can they
help
me?
To say, nice guy.
Guys,
be comforting.
No time. Just hang in there.
No, thank the ancestors, please, hurry.
Just stay calm and try to breathe normally.
I'm still seeing double
yeah.
normally. I can't concentrate
okay.
for shite.
I mean, yeah, I can do that.
God damn it! This is useless! It's acting as if this one room has been put into lockdown and it won't recognize my commands.
How much time does he have?
3 minutes before Pawn 64 is sucking on nothing but his own fumes.
I want them out of there, now.
We're trying!
I can't do this. I can barely see what's on my bloody screen here and my head is spinning off my shoulders.
Alana, tell me you and 32 could open that door
no,
without
apparently
yourself.
He wasn't good enough.
Oh yeah, no kidding. No kidding.
He
screwed up, basically.
It's almost entirely
I'm trying to contact the king.
Too much for him to
handle, something he can do.
He already had a splitting headache and this happened. He's just the headache just got worse.
To tell you.
Just tell you when we're through this.
No. You've got to listen to me right now. The cockpit, Bishop. During our last major repair, Angelov's bullets. The cockpit. Rook 9. It must be Rook 9.
Atmosphere returning to normal. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
Door should be open now.
Shouldn't be saying that.
Oh, I haven't even got that. I unlocked an achievement. Nice. I haven't actually done this in my Steam game.
100 plus hours of playthrough.
His pawn is dead.
No shit, Karen. Your lack of compassion, brother, is really getting on my nerves.
I'm sorry if my professional detachment bothers you, sister.
You mean your bloody emotional detachment from everything? And how many of us have to die
perfect.
For some bastard?
Just saying that.
All right now. I want an explanation. Six?
Just keep pushing on Rook 9.
Rook 9 was to blame.
Excuse me? I'm already feeling pretty useless today. The last thing I need to be is blamed for this.
Settle down, Wade. Everybody, just settle down. We already know someone has managed to get inside Zenmil's systems. And if it was Wade, then he frankly could have killed us all hours ago and handed the ship over to Kirill.
Good point.
Just quickly, I'm going to answer. Why do rooms have depressurization systems? It's more like the entire plane has air pressurization systems, right? Every chamber can have air be pumped in or pumped out. This fan is just an air circulatory system of the aircraft, and so if someone really wanted to, you could suck all the air out of any room or any section of the plane. Which one's the best one to kill? There's something about Zendo's last repair in the cockpit.
No, third one. Yeah, Wade has a different part in today's little games. It's still pissing on Wade.
Games? You think this is some bloody bastard game? Where you can just hit load and everyone comes back to life? Wouldn't that just be fucking grand, AP?
It is.
Wait! That is quite enough!
Yes.
He had fun doing that line in the studio.
Yeah.
He's like, you're gonna let me say that? All right.
Odd. Wade, did you hear what 64 said?
No, boss. I was a little busy trying to help.
He's lying.
Christ, Bishop, take it easy on me, will you?
We can be confident Pawn 64 was mistaken in pointing a finger at Wade. If that's what he was actually doing. Okay, everyone. So here is the score. First, Wade. I want our auto-weapon systems operational yesterday.
Okay, boss. I'm on it.
Once that's finished, I don't want any more macho nonsense. I want you in the med bay so Rook 13 can look you over.
I was planning on it. I'm sorry I couldn't help Mackay.
It's not your fault. You did what you could. Six, I want to see you in my office immediately. It's the last cabin on your left before reaching mission box.
Funny little thing here.
I've already locked down that section of the plane, and after you speak to me in my office, you are to have no further physical contact with the crew until we reach Ireland. Is that understood? Yes, that is one place you can go, after you come and see me. There, or your cabin. The entire VT system is directly interfaced with the King himself to prevent tampering. If Zendel's systems are compromised, then that
way to the door,
is
she's
just
there.
About the safest
so she
place
gave you a specific
you
reading. If you're there right on time.
Now, does anyone else have anything pertinent to add?
What if we have a mole on board? A pawn, maybe. I don't know. What else could this be? Tell me I'm wrong.
There's no.
It does change the ending. If you quit, if you officially agree to quit the consortium,
it's as simple as that. One step at a time.
That can change the ending.
And first, let's get to Ireland.
Turns out what
yes,
Kate Sheen says.
Of course, you're right. Hey, Bishop. Wait, just one minute. This is a private channel between us, so please speak freely. You've been spending some time with the crew since Pawn 7 was killed, and I was thinking, if
thinking.
You even had a guess as to who
thinking.
May be responsible, I could keep an eye out. Maybe we'd get lucky?
So we're not going to choose, is that right? Choose the wrong person?
Is that another plan?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just like that. Well, all right.
Pawn 12.
I guess we'll
as
see
as
what we see.
If anyone actually thought it was Pawn 12. Split personality? I can understand that. He goes into a murderous personality.
Yeah.
That would fit him, I guess.
It was like a clown or something.
Good.
Murderous
nice
clown.
And prompt.
Plot twist.
Some logic for that.
My office. Six. I don't want to be near you any longer than I have to right now.
Be near you.
Wait, the way he is. So, please, have a seat. So, I haven't asked you here to berate you with questions about my dead or nearly killed officers. There'll be plenty enough of those in Ireland. Nor am I going to ask you again why you think someone is causing all of this.
Sorry to interrupt, boss. I thought you should know that our auto guns are repaired and ready.
Good. Now, to the med bay.
Way ahead of you.
As you may have
one
noticed,
time.
Six,
yeah,
I care
died.
A
Jeez.
Great deal about this crew, and I also respect their opinions. Following what happened with Angelov, I've asked them to report.
She really does get pretty angry, yeah.
But before
see,
I get
and
to
the
what
entire
they
meeting,
have to say,
I'll go in there and start recycling their stuff.
Talk about you and
instant
I.
Shit list.
I feel like things have been a little rocky between us. Moving forward, I wonder, will this become a trend?
Yeah, because she doesn't like you. See, K-15's... She says we're pretty rocky between us because -3, yeah. Still deciding.
You're still deciding? Let's pretend I don't understand. What do you mean, exactly?
Decide if we're going to have a problem or not.
Shouldn't I be the one saying that to you? Look,
she's just so confused.
Do you want to be here?
Yeah.
Or
everything
not?
Is wrong with you.
Hogwarts, yeah, it's kind of funny. It is too. It's like Hogwarts, a little animated photo, like Hogwarts.
Oh,
that,
yeah,
it's yeah.
Good point.
Don't have much of a choice.
Most people would kill for your position, and you treat it like you've been forced against your will. I don't even care. Let's move on now to the rest of the crew. I trust and respect each and every one of them a great deal.
This,
and like
this is
I
one
said,
of the more
I've asked
potentially
them to
twisty turning conversations
yeah.
based on alignment, based on choices, based on
handled yourself
things.
Well.
Yep.
Most of the crew have
Always.
Nothing worth reporting. What about you? How do you feel you're fitting
magically
in?
Magically all fit together pretty quickly too. Didn't take a lot of iterations to make it work, which was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
A bunch of, whole bunch of alignment checks done. Yeah.
Do you have any idea what other people would give for your position? Any idea at all?
Give my position to other people, then.
If that is how you feel, consider it done.
Night 15, come in, please. It's Rook 13.
You do know that the CMC is not a radio, yes? You can just say what you want.
Yeah, Yanko's
okay.
One of the mercs.
We've disposed of
the mercs you talk about the hallway.
Body.
Mm-hmm.
His brother's Pitar, I think.
The
mm-hmm.
containment
yeah.
unit.
Pitar.
Thank you, Kieran. How's Wade?
Pawn 24 is treating him now. He will be fine.
Glad to hear it. Okay, so I will contact the King and inform him you will not be remaining aboard Zenlil. I want you off this ship before things get any worse. Effective the moment we land in Ireland.
Join your enemy! Hey.
Kick me out and I'll join your enemy.
Get the hell out of my office! Right now!
Kick me out and I'll join your enemy.
What now?
We don't have any enemies, so who would you join? That's the big question. No real enemies, anyways.
So I did not pick the right traitor.
I think we're in trouble.
Therefore, we're in trouble.
I don't think so.
This again. That only happens if you got trapped in the cabin with Pawn 64. You can only get that option.
Light show back here.
It's the virus.
This again.
I'm on my way back to the cockpit. 2 minutes.
I think something real bad is about to happen.
Well, now, who the hell are you?
Oh boy, I'm on hard, too.
Just
for a tough fight.
I'm here for him, not you.
Which is the voice acting for all
that
seeker speech around? Oh, like
voice.
The stuff in
take
the background?
Seeker.
That's from the ARG.
That's the Zenlo voice. Same person does the voice for Zenlo.
Some of that is pulled from the ARG stuff. Some of the soundscape.
All the seekers in here are from the are Zenlo saying seeker, pretty sure. Oh, there might be some other seekers in the ARG.
Some soundscape.
You're right. There's some in the ARG.
The
so it's like Colin, Peter, myself, Aline. Bunch of people. Bunch of people from the team.
You must have walked in on whoever that is as they were tampering with Bishop Bates' bus.
Be careful, Six. This
I'm not gonna cheat.
Of ours is clearly a little
I'm gonna
confused.
Take this guy out.
Do you have anything?
Only got I need another shield. So, thank you. Two would be better than one.
You're still gonna get your ass out, too. I mean, no, you're not.
Angela was nothing more than a means to an end. His EMP helped spread the virus.
You gotta blow
up
the airlocks.
He was never expected to succeed.
Why? Oh yeah, to kill people. Yeah, exactly.
This is to kill people.
Right.
64's already dead, so you can only do two of them.
Stay the hell off the second floor until further notice.
I'm in the cockpit now.
Good move, Wade. We don't want anyone getting in the crossfire. Come on! Now you can't.
Wade, can you track the traitor or not?
My senses are telling me there's bloody intruders everywhere.
Good for close range.
Including the cockpit. I can't tell what's real.
Oh no!
Oh no. Bugged out. That's no good. I heard about this bug. I've got to look into that.
Can you shift her before it blows out, maybe?
What's that?
Can you shift her on her seat before the rubble blows out?
I don't think so. She's in a vehicle, right? But she had the idea that she got sucked out of the
door
before.
That's bizarre.
I gotta figure out what's cause of that. I will do that. That's fidelity fixed to 1.26.
Oh god! Luca! We have to go!
She went to the wrong place. We have to go stand right by next to the door.
1.24 is already dead. Now this guy, however, can be... crap. No ammo. Darn. But... However, I do have energy at least.
Yeah, the bathroom being locked, actually, again, it's kind of a spoilery thing, but that's one of the hints you can figure out if that it's 32, is the whole bathroom factor.
Notice how her health is still low. That's sort of the way you can slowly win her down. So you gotta get through her defenses and her health. She doesn't use nanites as much as we do. So that's sort of the key to beating her on hard. You don't wanna wait too long to engage because she will heal herself. But yes, the galley. It's a bit of a pain to get to the galley. Hopefully it won't shut down before I get there.
And we've lost the galley.
Ah, god damn it! Okay. We need stuff to recycle. Luckily, I didn't recycle a lot of stuff. The galley itself is still full of juicy stuff. Yeah, good. Let's get some grenades.
That was something that we ended up writing and actually recording lines for the more stuff you recycle in the plane.
I used all the grenades already.
We were able to implement that, unfortunately.
Say again, what?
Well, we had lines done and recorded for the more stuff you recycle in the plane. They start talking to you.
Yeah.
They're like, why are you doing that? Stop recycling stuff.
That got that push that they did get cut.
Yeah, it was more work than we thought it was going to be.
She's probably healing herself. Where is she? Hunting her.
Yeah, taking the shields from Carol is definitely the best way to do it. That's the way to get geared up.
Or at least get the bad guy shields. You can...
So then he has like four of them.
Pair them. Someone broken. Yeah.
You can only get two Consortium mission points, I believe.
Very rare thing here. You can see that the combat shields are up in the medbay. In the event of anybody storming the ship. Where is she?
Okay, the barracks is next. Get there for some energy charge and goodness.
It's just down there. Where is she? It is.
The barracks charge station's online.
2-4, 2-4.
Too injured. Damn, I thought I could do it at one time. That's almost, it's definitely hard. Once you've got multiple organ failures, it's just even, nothing even the NAS can't keep up with the number of injuries you have. Hey, it's Ryan Schiffer.
Yes.
He's got beers.
Brought you one of these.
Did
you
the programmer of Consortium.
In London.
The man.
Yeah, but I almost did it. Gone. I could have totally done it. Keep pressure. You bring your health down, and you go and you charge up, and you go back and you apply pressure again. And you take her out. That's the way to do it.
Is it? Is it really? Is it okay? I do work out. No beer.
I would love a beer.
Wish we could give these folks nice folk beer. Let's give beer through the screen.
Thank you.
Ryan, say hi. Poke your head in.
Say hi to 10 people who are joining the stream or watching us play and talking.
Hi.
That's the camera there.
Ah, yes.
Everybody, it's Ryan Schaeffer. He programmed this game in C++.
Quite literally, he programmed this game.
And why am I doing this? To save countless lives whose existence will be snuffed out if you are allowed to live any longer.
They all want
it's
me
true.
To God mode.
God mode's not exactly. It's, you're just being yourself. Save your
life. That's tedious. I'm going to cheat. Fine. I guess in case just to...
Let's try and beat the game before we finish up.
Alright.
Stay the hell off the second floor until further notice.
I'm in the cockpit now.
Says, hi,
yeah, I can't beat her on the worst of all game. I can't. She just hands me down.
It is doing. I think what experience the hardest is that it starts to be realistic. Not necessarily fun. So.
Can you track the traitor or not?
Yep.
Yeah.
Try to get 19 and see if she goes out again.
Ah, there we go! Oh shit!
Well done. Just before the thing dropped.
Oh, because I'm god mode, so I can't die. So now I'm just floating in the outside. Alright. I can't because I'm god.
Just go type kill.
There you go.
So kill beats god.
God died. Who yeah. says god died? Note to self, don't stand in front of an open, busted airlock in an aircraft.
Do you want to see her fly out?
Him fly out.
Did he just say the Churchill Tower?
The Churchill Tower.
It may be a shield on it.
Well, that explains what happened at Port 7.
So there's storytelling for the tower threaded throughout this entire game. The setup.
This so-called officer of ours is clearly a little confused.
Do you have anything to say before you end this? Good.
All personnel, stay the hell off the second floor until further notice.
I'm in the cockpit now.
Good
men of Wade. We don't want anyone getting in the crossfire. Come on! Now's your chance!
Blood everywhere! So much blood! Way more blood than there should be.
Blood coming out of her helmet.
Wait,
yeah.
Can you
track the trace?
A little bit. Her health's going down a little bit, but there's like gouts of blood flying in her face. I mean, at least tells you you are twitching because of the whole thing. It's good feedback, but it's realistic per se. There.
You killed it?
Whoa.
Yes.
Did you just hit us? Can someone please tell me what?
Can you still grenade 19?
But the bishop didn't just find an empty suit.
I know it sounds crazy, but what if someone
they didn't trigger
animate the suit
to go over there? Can I hear you? Me? This is gonna bug out again. Friendly lost something.
For the kind of efficiency we just saw, the suit would have fallen much quicker.
What if somebody teleported from the suit?
I just wanted to
some
get
the
kind of
fail-safe recall system.
Where'd she go? See, this is where the bathroom was locked.
Bathroom is locked, now it's open.
She wasn't there before.
132 standing.
What else remains?
That does it. I'm not taking any more
see,
chances.
See, one person point
remote
out that
control,
they, that was
teleport,
in their
whatever. This day is slipping
kind of cool
further and further from our control.
Thing.
Wade, Patrick,
teleportation
the
is getting there
in
lore.
I've
not sure what you mean.
Quite enough fun for one day.
Okay.
Goodies. Get my full thing going. I can put on this.
Gonna miss.
Grab that sucker.
Flash somehow.
And recycle the device.
You're gonna miss Flash?
Somehow.
Recycle the device.
And I find myself humbled to
ask. Recycle this?
Yeah, recycle.
You can't.
That doesn't do anything.
That pops up.
21, 21, 21, 21, 21, 21.
That's actually binary, that does say something.
Does it really?
Yeah,
I forgot that. Hint. Everybody work out the binary.
While the day may have been long, unfortunately it is not yet over. I am now issuing security protocol X03.
Chat stream there, right?
All porn personnel will report immediately to the barracks until they
have
further notice.
It's not possible. They have auxiliary tech. I'm just trying to create CCU sharing between different
C3s. Until we touch ground in Ireland.
True. Yes,
Thank you.
You can't seriously be thinking of locking them in there.
That's
true,
the plan, yes.
Well,
do
you
have
can,
a better
you
idea
can mount
to help
that thing?
More of our crew members from dying or killing
just
each other?
Just
works.
Because
no,
I'm
this, this no, just an airstrike. That's just like, yeah, hitching it to your belt or something. You just get that.
In a room
best you can
a pissed
do.
Off, magically teleporting killer seems like a good plan to you. Alana.
Magically
don't
teleporting
don't
killer.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
You can't deny that you've been making.
Nope. Spoiler alert.
Early on, we're having that trouble.
Don't do
you
this.
Can. You will be able to bring that into the tower, though. That's for sure.
Oh, good.
It will have
a new bishop here really does have a brain.
I really don't like reminding my crew that this technically is not
you.
A democracy. They'll stay in the barracks.
Hey,
originally,
come on, people. Reality check.
We should be able to recycle it.
I mean, maybe
I think we turned it off here for because it's a super important item, and
right.
Because it's also
wait.
Super advanced. Maybe the PCU doesn't know what to do with it.
These
it's too advanced.
Give me some credit. I got this virus by the balls now that it's showing us its ass.
No, if you
very colorful.
No, if you have
two,
another one. Yeah, have one recycle the other. Just break it down. Yeah, technically.
So first being, I can't power down the system because there's a chip missing from the battery crawl control bank.
I've got it.
Oh, hey. I guess you've already found it. Okay, mate. Now take that chip to the battery crawl and plug it into the control bank there.
You're like twins.
Battery crawl is accessible from the hangar bay and the gallery.
It should be, yeah.
In the hangar bay.
Still, it's the last thing he saw.
Directly underneath the CCU.
Echoing.
That doesn't work. Yes, not bad. Stick the chip in.
That's fixed now. I need to reset them, unless it's
in. One chip's almost needed.
Hold on to
magical
your
chip.
Unknown error detected.
We're back up and everything is in the green. The virus is gone. I hope.
Good work. I think we can all breathe a little easier now.
Well, I'll be damned. Hey, guys. I think the virus may have tampered with our local newswire connection. There's a channel that wasn't there an hour ago, and yet it's most voted over the past 3 hours. There's some seriously strange stuff going on in London right now.
Oh, gods.
Let me guess. The church and tower.
You got it. And we've also got a second incoming TS packet from London.
This is not happening.
Let me pass the news whiteboard.
Yes.
Just a sec.
If this brief thunder snowstorm wasn't enough for one day, it's hard to believe that an unknown number of armed terrorists have taken control of the Churchill Tower. Supports are sketchy but conclusive.
See, we're doing something.
And I assure you, this
I've seen that before. Rook Dines thing gets stuck on.
Voice image recognition have confirmed the leader of the hostage takers is
that's
none
obscure,
other than
tiny obscure flash bug
Bin Laden.
Or something.
I assure you again,
Rook Dines thing is stuck
no
on.
Joke. Saad bin Laden,
I think it's playing
remember,
that because it
was thought
it's
to have been
this
killed.
Voice.
15
this voice has his own thing.
One of the final
things has a question mark thingy.
Your guess is as good as mine, folks. And all I can tell you right now is to stay
oh,
by
right.
the new.
I think it's because it was I was
like
in the inventory when this was
no
on.
More,
I get
so,
something
too.
About if you mess around with the inventory.
This is Malcolm Thomas.
He's talking
from London, England.
You can turn those
just outside the Churchill Tower.
Thought to have been killed. Saad was killed. Shot through the heart.
Maybe you
turn
we'll find out
if like
just goes off after
hand.
He stops. There it goes. Okay, there you go. It's all good. It's working.
Think, no,
it's
stuck
on.
I can assure you that
could very well probably
not
really
be
it. It's just it, I thought worked out.
We've had enough excitement
yeah.
for one day.
Ah!
Yeah.
Look!
Well,
it's people! How's it going? How's it going?
Don't you dare say
more IDGI folk arriving, folks. Think of our streams about to end, guys. We're having a bit of a get together to celebrate the fact that we hit our
seriously?
Funding goal.
Does he not
and,
know what we're being through today?
But we're almost done with the playthrough, so you guys want
to
just watch
everyone
the we'll finish the game.
We
can try to squeeze in somewhere.
Come on, do something. This isn't right.
Okay, everyone. You
all
right,
we're at the briefing. We're pretty close
meet
to the
meet in the hollow room on the doubles. Briefing in five. You 2-6. It seems you're a bishop again. At least until we hear what the king has to say.
Is anyone pro-church? It's pretty interesting. Comments.
I get the
question.
Most of the church is pro-church.
Don't be an asshole, Bishop.
Most
at
of the
least
don't be an asshole, Bishop.
It's not too much to ask.
So, everyone's just going to ignore me now. A bloody Bin Laden in London? This isn't just insane, it's some sort of practical joke. It has to be.
Howdy, howdy.
Today is proving to be full of surprises.
Shut up, Kieran. Six, go ahead and take a seat.
Okay,
we'll be getting started soon.
Poke your head in the camera and say hi.
Hello, Seeker. Yes,
I am. Ian and Mike.
I understand.
Small window there.
Yeah. Like the, my eyes just
there.
Creeping in.
Are you familiar with what they call their alternate reality game?
Do you know who I am?
Oh, you're super far in the game.
Yeah, almost done.
Almost done like a full
playthrough. Yeah, that's what I was saying. We wish you just complete the full playthrough.
You are the seeker of knowledge, of truth, of understanding. Your world has shaped my past and is directly responsible for my survival at an early age.
Okay.
I ask again.
Let's
do
this.
You know who
I am?
Piss
off the king?
The big K. Be patient. He's coming.
I've not played the ARG and I've never met you before.
I told Vidal it was a mistake to open this connection to the uninitiated.
This game you call Consortium was a mistake, and you will be accessed by those prepared to better this world through informed action.
Could you actually critique itself like that?
It's kind of hard keeping all the game lore straight.
My childhood, my fragile development stage, reduced to an ancillary alternate reality game, full of game lore. Your world certainly is a strange one.
Hard to believe any of this is real.
I can assure you, it is. Your world is the first to treat the
connection. Did
you
actually pull off to neutral? I heard somebody did that.
Was it Ford that did it?
That's impressive.
Ford, that was you? I saw the post of someone figuring out, figuring that out, which is absolutely an insane accomplishment. Truly awesome. The fact that you were able to do it, though, was really cool.
Well, I
suppose like this big, long, specific things you gotta do. Talk to this person, say this line, then do this, then say nothing, then go here, do this. This massive list. And at the end, zero across the board. Actually, what do we have, actually, right now? Got a whole bunch of twos and ones. Minus 10. King hates us.
Oh, wow. What did you do?
K-15 hates us. Minus 14.
What did you
do? I kicked myself out of the consortium.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Let's get to work. I'll see you soon.
Yeah, kill whatever pawns we could. got Pouncy Fork killed. Just a total asshole run.
Oh, nice.
To
nice.
People we can kill.
Pretty easy with patience.
Okay, let's get this briefing over with. Something else I regret. This briefing's too long,
everyone.
Too involved.
The king tells
for the fact that none of
us.
You get to do none of this stuff in this game.
Display priority consortium.
This would be another good opportunity, like in the tower, to just cut
alpha.
To the chase. You can interject like that.
Yeah, exactly. The fact that you can speak any time means that we'll have all kinds of great contextual moments, where the player can just say "excuse me" or move on or whatever, instead of have your intention be known that you want to just get past it or whatever. That's a way to keep the action moving forward.
It's like diegetic cutscene skipping.
Yeah, kind of. That in combination with the whole speed up time thing, right? That was an idea for everyone time. They will hold on a button, or you can just tap and have it automatically speed up time to the end of the conversation or to the end of a line. You can just quickly zap through stuff. Yeah,
probably super
easy.
Allow
for replay. Yeah, for sure. Just upping the animation, upping the simulation speed, basically.
Yeah, it's like slow-mo, right? To slow things down, so I'm sure there's
the opposite, just speed it up.
Yep.
Yep.
So the
bishop. I don't know what you call it.
And the king has never steered us wrong before. Okay, let's hear the plan.
Good. We don't have any time to waste.
What does K-15 need to say in authorization code?
The
user holder. Actually, what that is, she's confirming a secure code. So that it's all about the encryption and securing a line that no one else can tap into. It's extremely secure. So she's basically officiating that code by doing it. It's not so much using their holodroom as it is acknowledging
James
a priority one signal from the king.
Sorry,
and
rule three.
Beginning official
a
consortium
surprise.
Mission briefing.
I thought you'd been abducted.
Yep.
I haven't
it's
heard a word
code
in
code
months.
Use, right?
Yeah.
It's
exactly what she says, how she says
certainly
in her voice.
Been a while.
Yeah, the whole 9 yards.
Things
yeah.
have been pretty crazy up here lately. Disarming Stroman and Global was a real bitch of a job.
You say one thing for sure.
Are you all right?
We will be recasting Rook 3.
Oh, no, really?
He'll have a different voice in the top. It's probably
the
only character we're for sure going to recast. He's an awesome voice actor, and he also does Night 18. We're definitely keeping him for Night 18. He's perfect Night 18, yeah.
But
we never quite nailed Rook 3. Rook 3 is.
You
just have a different vision for him. It needs to be different.
He's too important in the second game to have.
Yep,
he didn't have any confidence.
Yeah, yeah.
But he's kept us alive well enough.
We actually, I'd be cool to get a voice actor like Marcellus Wallace.
That sounds like you saying
something. That would be badass. That'd be really cool. You're Bing Rhames. Yeah, Bing Rhames voice actor. That would be badass. That to me, that's Rook 9. That's Rook 3. You can hear him talking about his daughter. Imagine him talking about being on the thing. You better save my daughter or I'm going to freaking kill you.
What did you just say, you little maggot?
You see, on
a little maggot, you just called me a maggot.
Loving vulgarity. Lensworth here is just a mean old bastard.
Rook 3?
His character will be the same,
bad.
Just the actor needs to be different.
Al
just needs
yeah.
a little more confidence in the
same.
More badass
issues with the accent. wasn't confident doing the southern accent thing.
Yep, exactly. And it's someone who can really do the southern accent for realistically. Yeah. Just bigger, sounding more badass, more macho.
What's going on?
How long have you been sleeping?
I don't know, 5, maybe 6 hours.
He needs to have
Why?
Equal presence as K-15.
Somebody
yes, he does. Bravado. He needs a much bigger, deeper voice.
I will explain.
More,
please,
yeah, more presence.
You're running low on time. The Churchill Tower, built over the River Thames, near the financial district of London, England.
Oh, God. Did the damn thing blow up?
No.
It is Christmas.
It's Christmas. Yeah. What was that about?
Darcy and the other hostages have been unharmed.
No.
Hostages.
Spoiler: Darcy is a Lannis and Rook 3's secret.
I know my birthday.
Oh God. That's why they hate each other.
That's why they hate each other. It's now canon. All right.
Canon.
Now, as I was saying, the Churchill Tower is the second tallest building in the world. Standing at 840 meters and consisting of 208 floors, including those below ground.
The top 43 floors are in mid-construction and will soon
So a lot of this information is just wrong. The look of the tower is wrong, and a bunch of stuff's wrong.
Yeah, but that's again.
No,
that's satellite. Anything in here is satellite
like
giving you very
Bishop
basic version of what you're actually seeing.
I agree. I think everything to do with the tower is obfuscated and kind of broken when it comes to how much is known about it in this stream.
I can promise you that.
So that does account for all the errors which do exist. No, I'm kidding, Bauer. That's not going to be canon. Kidding. No. Don't worry. Darcy is not Alana's Rook 3 secret kid. No. It's not like you or any. She keeps saying that. That's awesome. I think honestly, if you guys enter the tower with super high alignments, any of the characters, it could go there a little bit. It could be sexual flirtation.
Guys or girls?
Guys or girls? There's no exactly. We very much try to write the bishop without any particular sex in mind. That's why you can have a conversation with the queen, and you can talk about having a girlfriend or a boyfriend, and it's just irrelevant, right? Much as possible, we want to forget the fact that the host is technically a male, and instead allow you to just imprint whoever you are into the character. As much as possible, it wants this to be about you, the player, being involved in the story, not some other character you're trying to go play.
It's Bishop 2 all over again.
I'm
unless
sure Bishop
you have something
6
useful,
would really
Adelina,
appreciate that.
Please.
you mean Bob, you mean?
When he comes back out of
Bob Jenkins?
Oh, it is.
That's the name of the post you take over. Yeah.
When you leave him.
Conversation.
Suddenly all these guys start flirting with you after you leave.
Flirting with
him.
What was I doing? <What's that? laughs>
Well, you tell Bishop 6 that this trap is shaping up to swallow him whole.
What an asinine analogy. He's a bishop.
One cool thing, this entire briefing was done in ensemble. We had all the actors in a room together. Same lines talking, this was like a play almost. We had each of them had their own mic and we were just
by British authorities.
Or sometimes we had two people come in. It was back and forth. We had two people come in. I sure hope this translation is good.
Oh, yeah. Let us know.
It's actually kind of funny, the voice actor, who this is, the story behind that. I won't go into that right now, but at some point it may go into that. It's just a funny story, how we found this guy.
Now you got it, though. You brought it up. He was hanging. I've got a really cool story, but I'm not going to say it.
Well, Paul found him, and he was sort of just, he just did it. It was hard. He found him on, like, Craigslist, I think. We found him on
Craigslist.
Yep, need Arabic voice. Yeah.
It's a good voice, though.
It's really good. It does. We actually did multiple takes with him. He did an initial batch, and then we gave him feedback and said, no, it's not quite right. Do it again.
A holy crusade. NAU conspiracies
Craigslist.
Are suffering the wrath of God.
About a bad Pakistan. We called up our buddies in Pakistan and they hooked us up.
And the men fighting for him should not exist.
We also have no idea.
I'm kidding.
The kidding system is being on site. And this makes them highly
bad
dangerous.
Joke. Some people might consider that to be bad humor.
Disinformation is involved, but the threat is real.
So if it's
come
not
on,
weapon,
be over already. I honestly, if I was going to redo Consortium, I totally would have had very little to do with the Churchill Tower. It would be all just subtle hinting. The first game would have ended much more of like a slice of life, and everything would have been happy and yay, everything's fantastic. You win, yay!
And maybe down the road.
But you live and learn. I mean, I always have hindsight. You can always look back and go, oh, if I could redo it, I'd do this and this. That's just life, right? No matter what it is you make, you always go back and want to change stuff. But.
Would you consider a remake down the road? Say if game 2, game 3 are successful.
I'd love to do like a HD upgrade where we take all the content, all the stuff, we just give it a massive, massive upgrade and just polish. Should have been a new engine, so that'd be awesome. Yeah.
Just a remastering, right.
Not a remastering, but we could tweak things. We could totally tweak things. Yeah, I can see us changing and having fun with it. Yeah,
and everything else.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
You can port everything.
Yeah,
Unreal Engine is what you mean. Don't want to use Source ever again.
No, of course not. No, this would be Unreal. It'd be an HD complete remake, like in the new engine.
Yeah.
Like once we got everything working in Unreal, but there's a reason we couldn't do that.
Yeah, but you
got to
port the entity system.
9:15.
The entity system.
British police, of course, have been explaining to this Bin Laden how ridiculous his.
Oh, you mean it's literally ported? No, I'm saying we could. I'm saying we could remake. I'm saying we could just take all the content and remake it with our new system.
This is your.
Oh gosh. No.
Hey, if it was easier to literally port over the data. Yeah, that's kind of interesting. Yeah. That's an interesting discussion in itself. Yeah.
Of course, we're
so maybe when
it is so
like literally take the VMF data and find a way to port that into real.
That's what I would try.
That'd be pretty awesome.
Trying to do all the scripting over again.
Right.
Hell.
Yeah. I will leave the remaining details in your capable hands.
Well, Gunspawn, yeah, that
I've got some catchy
loop scope.
I'll see y'all at
Best with a focus on Kirill, maybe an actual crash landing of Xenowitz ends at a fight at an airport.
Whoa.
All right.
that's revisionist history.
Brooks, I want you to start prepping by studying schematics and all the other background data that's been supplied.
Dire 2. Airports are cool.
Boss?
This is another strange bug. He walks sideways all the way to the cockpit at the end of the briefing. Every single time. And I have the foggiest clue why. It makes no sense whatsoever. I know. I know.
My AI doesn't
do that. Look at this. It's the whole way. I'm going to the cockpit and I'm going my way.
Yeah, jeez.
K-50 launch yourself in our office. Some of the conditions we added. Yeah, quick, late.
Finish it.
Do it. Whoom.
Is that?
Ignore him.
Oh, that's right. You gotta talk to them. I'm gonna go trigger this first.
It's about time you showed up. You fight incredibly well, Bishop. Almost too well.
That's
sure.
Do you know where I'm really from?
Where you are from? I know you are a tree-hugging Canadian. Why does this matter?
Another dimension.
Oh, good for you. And I am actually from Russia.
I don't know who to, I need your help. I don't know who to trust.
Next you will tell me you're on my side, yes? That you understand me. The other dimension thing was a strange touch, but I have heard it all. Save your breath.
I don't know.
I haven't heard this in a long time.
Whatever it is you're trying to accomplish.
Yeah. See, it is. What's his alignment?
No, he's zero.
Zero, okay. I'm not Bishop
Six. I am intrigued. I was assuming some form of K1 mind control was at work here, as my men have always suspected with your kind. But now you say you are simply not Bishop Six?
Good. He knows something. Keep him talking.
I don't remember this conversation. I haven't had this in a long time. My behavior earlier today.
Let's not keep playing games.
This is where you can hint at what Bob Jenkins was doing before
you
took him over.
But does your crew know of your bizarre brand of treachery? How you first helped me, only later to defeat me.
What is he talking about?
I have no idea.
I had a feeling you might say that. 3 times this morning, I spoke with you, Bishop Six. You are who initiated Phase 1, and you also told me to blame Rook 13 if the chance arose. I assumed you were testing my resolve, and so I played along.
He had better be messing around. Alana, stay out of this. I mean it. He's attempting to turn us against each other, hoping we'll believe anything after today.
I'm just gonna walk away.
It's all set to go. Just lock yourself in here and stock up. Once you choose, there's no going back until you return to Zenling. Oh! And make sure to grab a freefall suit, or you're not going anywhere.
Yeah.
So, Bishop, once you're sure you have what you want, let me know and we'll get you off this boat.
I think you can if you're really determined.
That is the best song.
Yes. Okay, actually, it's a bit of a pain in the ass. I'm going to have to just vent a bunch of this. There you go.
If you jump off without your free fall suit, you die.
So, are you ready yet?
Good question.
Good. Okay, sir. Stop talking. Ready to break heads.
We're already in a circling pattern around the Churchill Tower. Open the hangar bay door and wait for
Bishop Corpse still laying on the ground. Well, that's Bishop Corpse. I guess it looks like a Bishop Corpse. It's just a suit.
That's the empty suit from the fight, for the traitor's fight.
We're in position, holding just above most of the turbulence from the storm. We should be able to get a steady for your jump.
Bishop, it really only looks worse.
Cool thing is, if you go up backwards, you get to look at it backwards.
Good luck down there, V.
We end game approaching.
Bishop did a backflip there. That's my personal <Yeah. mechanic. laughs>
Went off the style. Looks like chunkers. You know what those are, actually? Those things flying behind it? Looks that actually is a whole bunch of entities that are in place. And the model of the plane is flying forward. Those entities are staying in place.
It's strange time again.
Yes, it is.
But it looks kind of like chunkers flying from the plane.
There is no
question
that we have all been taught the ultimate test today. And in my mind, we have so far succeeded.
Was this transition to the level of those entities?
The king is asking for our blind trust and
exactly.
patience.
Exactly, it's a transition.
And I,
well, why don't you delete those?
Just something that just... It's almost like I see it and it kind of looks cool. Like you don't even know what they are. It's just chunkers coming off it. It almost kind of works in the right?
Yeah, like an intended mode.
Yeah.
That being said, I want to thank him for putting these differences aside for now.
See? See, this is what you get. If you get kicked out of the consortium, she has this speech where she talks about having differences.
And while I do not entirely agree,
King says we need him. And she's about to say, I don't agree with that. This guy's an asshole.
Followed by 27 minutes of snow. Here at home.
The first time I played, I thought this was supposed to be like a close time loop when I got to here. Is that the game would immediately repeat over and over again. And I thought that's the direction the game is going to go.
Whoa.
It's not, but
like, you thought you'd be able to play the entire game now from this point?
Yeah, the game would immediately start again.
I see. Bizarro. Yeah, okay.
If we'd done that, we could have thrown in hints that you had played the game.
The structure of the game would have become hideously crazy complex.
That's like a Star Trek episode.
Yeah, exponential complexity.
I'm so sorry to wake you.
But someone mentioned source code. Someone earlier mentioned that our game literally is like a game version of source code. It's kind of funny that source code came out in 2011. So we were all like watching that movie right before we started production of Consortium. We were like, oh my god, this is like what we want to do. This is like so triple freaky. It was kind of inspiration from the team at that time to like make a game that essentially does that.
But you have nothing to worry about.
You guys have all seen that, right? Source code?
No.
No?
No, I haven't.
You haven't seen it? Oh, must see. The guy gets zapped into someone's head on a train. And there's like a bomb somewhere on the train. And he's got to try to find the bomb. But every time he fails constantly. But he gets zapped back in time. So he has constant time travel getting zapped back in the head to try to find the bomb. And he learns more every time. And he keeps learning more every time he gets zapped into his head, right?
That does sound cool.
It's pretty sweet.
Okay.
Great
what the hell was that? Two near hits in a row. I'm running
it's
a diagnostic.
Lived there,
Repeat.
Oh, yeah.
Most named it.
I
had two names.
I
wanted to
steal.
Edge of Tomorrow.
That's a fun movie.
It's
really good. Yeah, those are badass stuff. The art direction of that movie was phenomenal. The whole thing. It was awesome. Yeah. Yep.
The bishop's lighters are fluctuating.
Oh, my God.
It's a fantastic concept artist behind all that.
Yeah.
Six. Get to Bishop 8's cabin. When you're ready, hit the lock and wave your hand.
iDGi is really confused. You're getting scenes you did not get in the game. That's always the way. That's always the case.
I'm detecting
possibilities. Well, the idea was that I was trying to hit the people, showing the different possibilities. Good trigger.
I'm not about coming to you
based on your choices.
Today, I don't think there's much of a choice. Well, you won't take another hit. So, are you ready?
Apparently, I will take one more hit. Early glimpse of the Churchill Tower with cranes.
With cranes.
Yeah. I was really confused at that point.
Modern tower construction.
Trust nobody.
I just things.
It's kind of a freaky to wander the void.
Just be ready.
There's so many potential lines that can trigger. So many. Steve, how many did you end up forwarding to me? like a couple hundred or something.
Yeah,
possible.
I think we have a folder in the tower project with all those lines in it.
Okay.
It's probably
all the limbo lines.
Wasted code. But
well, I think there's going to be an equivalent of limbo for the tower, right?
So, yeah, that's true.
So we can totally throw all those lines from the first one in and mix in with all the tower lines,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, oh man.
The end of game one. Thanks everybody for joining us on the stream. It's really awesome. We're going to hang out now. and celebrate our funding victory. Thanks guys for joining us. Thanks a lot for your support. Keep helping to spread the word so we try to see if we can get some stretch goals.
But yeah.
No, we didn't. Oops. Let's just see. Let's just cap off what we did here. So this is what we did in today's playthrough. After acting strange in conversation, Rick 25 suggested you go and see Rick 13, the doctor, to ensure you're doing okay. As she suggested, we went to the medical bay, and a brain scan was performed on us, resulted in highly unusual readings. Kirill and his homeless mercenaries showed up, and you managed to keep Angela calm enough to allow 915's deception. A firefight broke out, where Angela was incapacitated and thrown in the brig. During the homeless mercenary encounter, Pawn 1 was killed by experimental weapons fire. Upon investigating the crew about Pawn 7's murder, Pawn 4 led you to believe it was Pawn 32 who was guilty. Pawn 32 denied this when confronted. At the meeting with the Queen, you also met Knight 18 at the Stormbird. He seemed to know something about who you really are, but to what end? On your way to the virtual trainer, Pawn 64 approached you. Planned for a minute of your time. You agreed, he proceeded to tell you about the calls to Bulgaria being made for the medical bay over the past month. Just before his death, he also told you the mole could be weighed, as he believed some sort of secret upgrade was made in the cockpit to protect against Angela's experimental weaponry. The air was then let out of the cabin, the door locked down, presumably by the virus. Pawn 64 died due to Wade being unable to concentrate following the incident in lower avionics, where Rick 13 barely saved his life. That's a mouthful, that one. Rick 25 asked you who she should keep an eye on as potentially Pawn 7's murderer. You guessed wrong. Because of the incident in Pawn 64, you were forced to meet Knight 15 in her office. In Knight 15's office, you told her you wanted off the crew, and she agreed it was for the best. You were approached by someone wearing Bishop 8's old gear, the person's face and voice were masked, making it impossible to tell who it was. The mysterious assassin disappeared from the armor when nearly taken down. You went to the brig and spoke with Angelov. Angelov blamed the real Bishop 6 and the Consortium for setting everything up. He said, "The king is playing games." You jumped from Dunlow. Bishop 6 was possibly killed in the process. Yeah, so that's our playthrough today.
Woo!
Woo! Yay.
Thanks everybody.
Thanks guys.
You guys rock. Talk to you the next stream, if not earlier. There may be an earlier stream, me just doing dev work on a level. But if not earlier, then it'll be Wednesday at 1 p.m. We'll be back. Thanks everybody. Don't choke on champagne. The advice is don't choke on champagne.
If I do what I want.
I think we all intend on choking on champagne, actually. So sorry. Hey guys, have a good one. Thanks a lot.